Even after a remarkable playoff run in the spring, a new season brings new faces to the mix, and the Flyers newcomers will don the orange and black for the first time in a game tonight as the Flyers open their 8-game preseason schedule in a home date with the Devils next. Yes, new faces, also a new name for their home building. It's now the Wells Fargo Center here in South Philadelphia, and the fans are certainly ready for some Flyers hockey. They're chomping at the bit for a new season after that magical run last year in the spring. And they'll get some hockey tonight. Preseason action, the Devils and Flyers here from the Wells Fargo Center. And a pleasant good evening. Welcome to Flyers preseason hockey here on the Comcast Network. Along with Keith Jones, I'm Jim Jackson. Steve Coates will join us here in just a moment. It's great to be back.
Fantastic to be back. Hockey back on the ice. Fans coming to the games again. And the Devils-Flyers matchup to start it. Seems like training camp just started. They get to the exhibition games pretty fast now.
They do, just 3 days later. And a lot of excitement surrounding this Flyers team for sure. Of course, the great run last year. But they have made changes. As many as 6 potential new players to the mix. And we talked to Captain Mike Richards and asked him how those newcomers might fill the holes.
Well, I don't think there were holes before, but I think we've improved on the places that we've got them. I think our depth on defense is probably the best in the league. We're very comfortable with our goalie situation, our forwards. I think we were just talking about it over dinner the other night of how much depth we have there, too. So it's nice that it's spread out. It's not needed to be counted on, you know, one line or one person every night. It's spread out, so I think that's the biggest thing that we have going for us this year is our depth in all positions.
Yes, they certainly are a deep team, Jonesy. Let's talk first about the newcomers up front, because the Flyers, well, they've added some skill, they've added some grit, they've added a lot of different elements.
They really have. They lost some skill in Simone Gagné. They went out and picked up Nikolai Zhirinov on a 1-year contract for a couple million bucks. There's his numbers in his career. He's been away from the National Hockey League for a season, playing in the KHL. He's back now and motivated. Bill Guerin out to make the Flyers. He's on a tryout. Here, there's the numbers for Guerin. They speak for themselves. He won a Stanley Cup, obviously, a couple of years ago with the Penguins and was a contributor to the Devils as well. Jody Shelley, though, brings the size and the toughness, the grit and the character. He brings it all in a couple of big games at the end of the year for the New York Rangers against the Flyers. Bill Guerin had a lot of big games against the Flyers in his career. Also played for the Islanders, the Devils, and, of course, the Penguins. Nikolai Zhirinov played for the Rangers a couple of seasons ago. He led them in scoring. He is a very talented goal scorer. Some question marks about his work ethic, but he's surrounded with some tremendously talented and a lot of character players here with the Philadelphia Flyers. It should be a great fit.
All right, that's the story up front. How about on defense? Of course, last year on their way to the Stanley Cup Finals, they relied on the Big Four. Well, Steve Coates, they've added to that Big Four. In fact, some feel the Flyers now have the deepest defense corps in the NHL.
I don't disagree with anybody saying that, because I think Paul Holmgren did a great job in going out and filling that 5 and 6 and actually 7th position by adding big guys. I mean, it doesn't hurt to get a guy like Mazzaros, who's 6'2", and then O'Donnell and Walker coming in at 6'3". And look at the numbers. You can see that Mazzaros could put some numbers up as far as offense is concerned. O'Donnell brings the experience, over 1,000 games in the National Hockey League. And Matt Walker, he's a thumper. And on top of being a thumper, he'll drop the gloves when needed. And you know what? Sometimes he'll actually score a goal for you. But he's another big guy at 6'2", 218 pounds. And that's what you need back on the blue line. As Peter Laviolette was very happy to have these big guys there, with Sean O'Donnell being the experienced, stay-at-home type of guy. He loves to be able to take the body too. Mazzaros, I talked about his offense. In his rookie year, he had 39 points. He made the all-rookie team, and he led the National Hockey League in plus-minus. You hope he gets back to that type of attitude. Don't go away yet. It's coming up. It's the Philadelphia Flyers and the New Jersey Devils.
Tonight's Flyers-Devils game is brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. By Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. By Wells Fargo, when you're considering buying your first home, Wells Fargo is with you. Wells Fargo, together we go far. And by VWLocal.com. Go to VWLocal.com or your area Volkswagen dealer to learn more about great deals on all their new vehicles. Last season was a true breakout year for one Michael Layton. After a nice regular season run, he stepped in during the Flyers' magical playoff surge and was outstanding. Earning himself a two-year contract and billing as the team's number one netminder as training camp begins. Layton gets back between the pipes as the Flyers begin the preseason with the Devils after these messages. Tonight's first period on the Comcast Network is brought to you by Pepsi Max. Maximum taste, maximum energy, zero calories. And by Kia Motors. Kia, the power to surprise. The Wells Fargo Center here in South Philadelphia. Don't be alarmed, folks. Same building, just a different name. And Flyers will have this as their home rink here this year. They look to get their preseason started on the right foot here tonight against the Devils.
Let's take a look at our Kia Motors starting goaltenders for tonight's game. Johan Hedberg in goal for the New Jersey Devils. Just signed in the offseason. He comes in to play some games behind Marty Brodeur. That number remains to be seen. And Michael Layton back in goal for the Philadelphia Flyers. He also was an unrestricted goaltender this offseason. Paul Holmgren getting him re-signed and back in the fold here in Philadelphia for head coach Peter Laviolette. And they are ready to get things started again.
This time he gets to start from the very beginning of the season. He is happy about that. Gets his first training camp with the club. He has certainly stressed conditioning. The early days of training camp, and we're underway as the Flyers dump the puck in, and it's played by Johan Hedberg, and the Devils look to move up their captain, Jamie Langenbrenner, to Jason Arnott, picked up in a trade with Nashville during the offseason, to Patrick Elias for a shot, and the quick save made by Layton. That's Langenbrenner, setting it off a skate to Arnott for a shot, another save, Layton rebound, Elias shot, save, Layton in the rebound, stuffed that, and I believe Layton had to make another save as you look at the fly line combinations, an early flurry from the Devils. Puck staying in the Philadelphia zone. And Kimmo Timonen will move it back around behind the net. Now the line combinations, Jonesy, not necessarily what they've been using in the practices. As here's Zhirdev with a shot and a save made by Hedberg. You get an idea of some of his skill right there.
Let's take a look at our virtual lines for tonight's game for the Flyers. There they are. Nikolai Zhirdev playing the left side, the right-hand shot. You saw how elusive he can be. Richards at center. Carter playing the right side. Briere back in the middle as he was in the playoffs last year where he excelled. Claude Giroux also at center. Carter, the guy that's going to be on the wing here tonight, and that will change as this season moves along. Four top-notch centermen to play in the top three lines.
Look out here. Devils moving up. Pass across. Dinis Zubrus trying to get that shot off and the feed from Henrik Kalita, the former Saber, but he could not get the shot on goal. Here's David Clarkson with a pass that goes off a stick. Kalita tried to keep it in. Ricochets off Van Riemsdyk. And then it goes to Bill Guerin wearing uniform number 9, but he's run off the play by Talinder, and the Devils get it back. Both teams have some youngsters in the lineup, although the Devils more than the Flyers, which isn't a surprise. They're the road team. You have to have at least 8 regular players by rule, and both teams have comfortably made that. As James Van Riemsdyk will flutter that one into the Devils' zone. Claude Giroux in after it. Pounds into Mark Frazier, the defenseman. And the Flyers get to the puck. Andreas Knotel out toward the point. Could not be kept in by O'Donnell, and so the play is offside.
Well, guys, I'll tell you one thing. We're all looking forward to such a great season, but an addition, and a surprise addition, an exciting addition, could be Bill Guerin. Now, Bill Guerin's 40 years old, but boy, I'll tell you what, he brings an awful lot to the table. He can shoot the puck, he knows where the net is, and obviously he brings a ton of experiences to a hockey club that certainly is on the verge of winning the big one. So that ability to have him in your lineup is something to look forward to, and I just hope he makes this hockey club.
Yeah, there's no question about that. He's already made an immediate impact in the locker room. He's a guy that really seems to fit here in Philadelphia. So some difficult decisions for the Flyers to make, and Bill Guerin's going to make it as hard as possible. And I would not be surprised at all to see him stick with this team.
Giroux, nice feed to Knotel for a shot, and the save made by Hedberg. Oh, Giroux, nifty little feed, and Knotel got a lot on that shot, but Hedberg able to make the save.
Yeah, Knotel, one of those guys that's trying to make this team. He played very well in the playoffs last year. He was in the lineup for 10 games as a very solid player at both ends of the ice. Would like to score a little bit more in the National Hockey League level. When you play with Claude Giroux, you're going to get a lot more opportunities. One of the best passers on this Flyers team, and Andreas Nodal trying to take full advantage of his opportunity in this game.
Devils break out in a 3-on-2. Brad Mills with the puck. His pass back into the middle, tipped away, bounces around, and skitters wide of the net. Picked off there and set along by Ben Holmstrom. Rookie tried to open some eyes for the Flyers. He was signed as a free agent last March. And he has been very good. Was good briefly with the Phantoms late last year, and then again here early in camp has impressed the brass. So he gets some time here tonight. Pass across. Bryce Salvador's shot blocked off by Ian LaPerriere. He picks up right where he left off last year, but using the bottom portion of his body as opposed to his face to block that shot, that's probably a better idea.
And Ian LaPerriere, for those fans that are wondering, is going to wear a shield this year. He made a promise to himself last year and is going to carry that forward, and he's got it on obviously in the game tonight.
Here's Zhardev revving it up through center. He's 1-on-3. Cuts to the left, dangles, and then flips it around behind the net, hoping for Jeff Carter. Carter, Richards, and Zhardev the line, with Richards in the middle. Richards trying to break that outlet pass up. It bounces free, and it's played along by Alexander Urbom, promising defenseman for this Devils team. Up ahead it goes to Arnott. Arnott with a pass through to Langenbrenner, but his shot was going wide, went off of Layton. Braden Coburn there for Philadelphia, ahead for Richards. 3.5 minutes in, first period, no score. Glad you could join us on the Comcast Network for the first hockey of the season. And the guys, even though it's only been 3 days, 3.5 days of training camp, they're happy to see guys in other uniforms, right?
I'll tell you what, they come into camp in such great shape. They have a few practices. They're back on the ice playing games before they know it. Actually, a pretty good way to approach training camp. I hated the first 2 weeks when I was playing because it was living hell trying to get yourself into shape. These guys come ready to go, and you know, it really pays dividends for everyone. Makes it a lot easier on the head coach because he can get his lineup out there as quick as possible.
And I thought you kept yourself in tip-top shape all the time, no?
By Christmas, I was feeling pretty good.
And then, of course, in January, you were wearing down, right?
Correct.
Here's Fraser for the Devils, widening it up, but not out. There's Mazaros keeping it in, along for James Van Riemsdyk. Van Riemsdyk worked awfully hard and put on some weight in the offseason, strengthening his upper body and lowering his body fat. And so he is hoping for a good start here. Van Riemsdyk, take it into the wall by Frazier, but stuck with it and poked it free to Nodal. There's Nodal dropping it off now for Tiemannin. Tiemannin around behind, looking in front. Centers, Van Riemsdyk poked at it. They poke around, and now it's Hedberg getting a hold of it and hanging on. That one batted out of the air by Van Riemsdyk, and then also, I believe, in front by Briere. And somehow found its way back to Hedberg.
James Van Riemsdyk had some dominant games against the New Jersey Devils last year and is trying to really have a strong season this year. He's got the strength to go along with it. Kimmo Tiemannin jumping down in the offensive zone, and Danny Briere knocks that one out of the air. Hedberg makes a quick save.
Well, Banfield, the referee, was standing right in the right spot. His father was a referee in the National Hockey League, Charlie. So he's right there, and he sees that high stick by Briere. He'd already made the call. But you can see the positioning of Van Riemsdyk. You're going to see a different James Van Riemsdyk this year because he's obviously bigger, he's stronger, but having that year of confidence now under his belt is going to be huge.
Got to be noted that in Coetzee's second foray on the air during a game broadcast this year, he complimented a referee.
Wow.
Right, Coetzee?
Way to go, Steve-O.
Well, I knew his father real well.
There we go. Claude Giroux dancing in front, shot save, rebound, pow, he scores! Yes, preseason, but Darryl Powell will get credit as he picked up the garbage in front and makes it 1-0 Philadelphia. Powell scores for a case of Tasty Cakes.
And it's Claude Giroux doing some nice dangling in the offensive zone. Darryl Powell started the play with a physical hit, and then he went to the front of that, found that loose puck, and put it in the goal.
Watch the positioning of all the three forwards. Look at them. You can tie a rope around all of them. Giroux with the initial play, the nice move that Jonesy had talked about. He's got such a great skill level. You just want to follow him around. And that's what Darryl Powell did. He looked like a halfback following the fullback, was right there with the nice rebound.
So Darryl Powell on the board, and it's a pretty important training camp for Darryl Powell. With Bill Guerin here, somebody is going to lose a roster spot if Guerin makes the team. And some have said it could be a guy like Darryl Powell, Dan Carcillo. Angle shot there by Palmieri, stopped by Layton. That's all, of course, conjecture. We don't know who the brass might be considering for that. But if Guerin makes the team, somebody who was on the team last year might not be on it this year up front.
Darryl Powell, an extremely important guy for the Flyers, though, because of his speed. He's got a real heads-up part to his game as well, getting pucks in deep and getting in on the forecheck. He's been a valuable contributor over the last couple of seasons.
He does a lot of the little things as that puck skips up into the Devils' bench. 1 second shy of 6 minutes into this first period.
Yeah, a little milling around going on there. Darryl Powell looking on. A little tap for Jody Shelley there. And Darryl Powell, one of the lively guys on that bench, Coatsy, down by you.
And you know, that's going to be one of the rules we're going to be really paying attention to this year. One of the new rules where they're really cutting down. If you get in any kind of altercation with a player off the ice, they're coming down with a hammer. It's not like you can push and shove anymore and get away with it.
Couple of alterations to the rules that we'll perhaps get into as the telecast moves along. Jeff Carter pushing that puck ahead to Richards. Richards moving up, developing into a 3-on-2. Richards holds, takes the shot, and Frazier got his stick on it and deflects it out of play. 6:24 into period number one. A good start for the Flyers. Darryl Powell pouncing at a rebound and giving them the early lead. Flyers with the lead, 1-0. The Flyers wearing their road jerseys here at home. In fact, they'll wear these jerseys, their new road jerseys, in every preseason game this year. Get fired up with the new 2010-2011 Flyers road jersey available at Fan Gear in the Wells Fargo Center or at PhiladelphiaFlyers.com. They're basically the jersey they had and wore the Winter Classic last year at Fenway Park, minus the patch.
Yeah, reminiscent of the whites that they wore in the 1967 season. And fans enjoyed that year. They enjoyed last year an awful lot, and they enjoyed a couple of years in the 70s.
Whoa, big hit. Cups. Sorry, Jonesy, big hit by Corrente on Jeredev. Knocked him down, but the Flyers stay after the puck and get to it. Richards trying to center. That deflects away, and here's Langenbrunner. And that was Jeredev trying to get back at a Devil as he took a run at Langenbrunner. Got a piece of him as the puck deflects all the way down the ice. Braden Coburn turned back. Richards maneuvers the puck to Walker, and now Walker is checked as the puck squirts free. Devils have it. Centering pass tipped away and then gotten back by the Flyers, and they'll move it ahead. Jeredev or Jeff Carter. Carter wearing an A. In across the line. Drop pass Jeredev, getting some room. Jeredev the shot, and that hit a body. He bounces out to Oscars Bartulis. Back to Jeredev. Dances in front. And wow, it's only taken two or three shifts, and you can see that this guy has tremendous skill.
And you see how he backs off the defense because of that skill level. Nobody wants to get danced, and Jeredev is going to find himself with a lot of open ice, especially playing with Richards and Carter.
Tried to stuff that one in with Zubers, but he couldn't keep control of the puck as he moved in front. And the Flyers able to move it out to center ice. Van Riemsdyk looking for it there. He's wedged off. Andy Green over there, so was Bill Guerin. Now it bounces back out to Bartulis. Bartulis in a battle for a roster spot with the three additions on defense. And his pass here is on the money to Guerin, who will wind and fire in the save made by Hedberg, and he'll hang right on to it.
Well, you don't want to miss out. Philadelphia Flyers individual game tickets are on sale now. This Flyers season is packed with great opponent matchups, promotional games, and giveaways. For tickets, call 800-298-4200 and visit PhiladelphiaFlyers.com. There is lower level seats available, and we had a lot of fun here last year, and now the Wells Fargo Center. And the fans here in Philadelphia look forward to another tremendous season.
And the opener on the 11th at 7 o'clock against Colorado. That's the home opener.
Yep, Monday night.
Games first. So it all get underway here at the Wells Fargo Center for real against the Avalanche. Here's Kimmo Tiiminen drifting back with the puck. Cross ice to Mazaros. Now he looks for Powell. He couldn't handle that one off the boards. Andy Green, who played very well for the Devils last year, ahead to Marcus Nielsen, the veteran. 2 years out of the NHL. He's on a tryout with the Devils, trying to get back in. Former Calgary Flame and Florida Panther. Around behind the net. Centering pass is blocked. Trying to get back to that is Alexander Vishunov for the Devils, but it's poked away. Back out to the point. The shot there by Erbom is blocked off by Claude Giroux. And Giroux will bank it ahead. Nodal after it there, and it bounces near the Philadelphia bench. Never did go in, and Erbom will bounce one back in on Leighton.
Claude Giroux already blocking shots out there, and Giroux playing with Andreas Nodal and Darryl Powell in this game. Already picked up an assist early on, and boy, the emergence of Giroux last year in the playoffs was something to be seen, and you can see the confidence in his game here to start training camp already.
Here's an outlet pass for the Devils, and looking for it is Nick Palmieri. God's country, Utica, New York. Have to mention it.
Sound like you know that area.
From there, centering pass by Palmieri and tried to get that one. It was LeBlanc, but it was stopped either by Leighton or the post. And it was hit up high. It would have counted according to the referee on the ice. Now a check on the wall as Walker battling for the loose puck. And finally he's poked ahead by Holmstrom, and now we've got our first fight of the preseason as Walker and LeBlanc go at it. Two guys who certainly know how to trade them. Pierre-Luc LeBlanc, 6'2", 220. Matt Walker, 6'3", 213 pounds. Both have their right arms cocked. And they both deliver rights at the same time. Helmet somehow staying on. A body punch from LeBlanc. Then he goes with a cross as Walker tried to counter punch. Linesman letting him go here. Now the crowd, they want to see punches. And LeBlanc obliges with a couple as Walker tried to get a couple as well. And they get rid of some of the padding, free up the arms. Over the top, Walker, but then it's LeBlanc who was ready for that one, and he retaliated, and down went Walker, and that will end that scrap. But a lengthy one, Coatsy, for our first one of the year.
Yeah, and I just hate that type of thing.
I know.
But in saying that, you know, obviously these guys had the same length of arms because they couldn't get at each other. But one thing I like about Walker, what he's going to do is when he gets a hold of LeBlanc, now LeBlanc's going to start it, Walker's obviously going to retaliate, and here they go. But what they do is when they do finally grab on, they're going to grab that jersey right up underneath the neck, and Walker likes to be able to move it back and forth, trying to catch LeBlanc off balance a little bit, move his head around a little bit. Watch that left arm. Trying to keep moving him around. LeBlanc doesn't go for it, and I don't really think Jonesy, there was a lot really landed in that one.
No, not a whole lot, but that's what Matt Walker brings to the table. He's got that element of toughness, willing to fight the other team's top fighters, which will alleviate some of that responsibility from other guys on this Philadelphia team, like Dan Carcillo, who had to step in there a bunch of times last year, Ian LaPerriere, Jody Shelley. They've got a lot of guys that can do that job and play that role. LeBlanc, a very tough player who's taken that job in New Jersey from Andrew Peters, who's no longer with the team, and Matt Walker's right there to face him and drop the gloves.
Five each for fighting. Flyers with the puck here. Centering pass. Jerdev's shot was blocked as Arnott stayed with him and denied him that opportunity. Matt Drenty, moving it ahead, and Arnott will wind it deep into the Philadelphia zone. Langenbrunner after it there. Back to the point to Fraser. Fraser wristing one. That's tipped away, and then Sean O'Donnell will get to it. O'Donnell, nice little pass there to Richards, and then back to Oscar Bartoulis, who gathers and then reverses to O'Donnell. John O'Donnell, 38 years of age, but he's played a lot of hockey in recent years. He's been very durable. High 70s last year in terms of games played. 2 years before that, he played in all 82.
Yeah, extremely reliable player and just an awesome guy. The Flyers very lucky to have Sean O'Donnell in the fold. He was with the LA Kings last year and just brings that element of character as well. So lots of arrivals and departures, Steve-O.
Well, you know, this is what I call our moving van graphic because the guys that left were Krejcik, Gagne, of course. Parent went back to Nashville. Cote became a coach up in Adirondack. Congratulate to him, Aaron Asham, and Ray Emery not back. And we'll get back to the arrivals in a few minutes.
They're all playing tonight, Coatsy, so we'll talk about them. That's for sure. We had a question mark next to Bill Guerin's name only because he's on a tryout. There he is with a pass in the middle for Van Riemsdyk. He fires one high off the glass. Salvador will twist it up the wall, but right there is Tiemannin for a shot. That one goes to the corner. Dinah Zubers over after it, and he'll move the puck ahead. David Clarkson looking for it there, but Tiemannin comes back and takes it away. One of those subtle plays by Kimmo Tiemannin. He's surrounded by Devils here. Gets some help from Van Riemsdyk, but the Devils still come away with the puck. Salvador at the point, dumping it back in along. But Josefsson looking for it. Not prospect for the Devils, comes away with the puck and drops it off. Shunov the shot, that's stopped by Layton. Shunov back after it, and he'll drop it off for Clarkson. Former teammate of Mike Richards, Kitchener, Ontario Hockey League. Josefsson stopped, and now the Flyers will move up with it. Danny Briere dancing his way in across the line, waits, finds Guerin. Guerin turning with it, holds, his centering pass blocked off by Salvador. Played up and out of the zone by the Devils, and all the way down, this will be icing on New Jersey.
Bill Guerin trying to make an impression early on. Nikolai Zhirdev, another one of the new additions, has had his chances already in this game. And again, you'll see the Devils' defense back up and in good position to block that shot. The puck seems to follow Zhirdev around the ice, though. He's always in a dangerous shooting position. Another European player that plays the offside. He's a right-hand shot that goes down the left wing, and those guys seem to know how to put that stick in a place where they can fire it quickly. And Zhirdev so far in this game showing some of those talents that he possesses.
You know better than anybody that it's an advantage to be able to play that off wing when you're facing the net all the time on the forehand, and you can get that shot up immediately. You saw Zhirdev on a couple of occasions with that opportunity.
Coach, I got to call you on this one.
Why?
That'll be the first and last time all year that we mentioned Keith Jones's shot in hands with Nikolai Zhirdev.
No. All I said was the thought process.
Hey, don't stop now. It sounded pretty good to me.
I didn't get into any skill level comments.
They got a little scrap here as Pau and Adam Mayer come together. There is a penalty upcoming. We'll tell you about that when we come back. Flyers up 1-0. And welcome back. The Eastern Conference champion Flyers are back here from the Brass, your favorite vets, and the new additions as they talk about last year's wild ride and the season ahead. Meet the Flyers, presented by Virtua, Thursday night at 9 on Comcast Sportsnet. Part of that show, Jonesy, it's always a lot of fun.
Had a chance for the fans to come out and meet the new Flyers. There's Andre Mazaros, and there's Nikolai Zhirdev.
Thinking, if only I could shoot like Keith Jones.
Yes, it also pays to be real slow when you play the offering like I was, because you're wide open by the time everybody goes past you.
Darryl Pau sitting in the box, gets two for roughing, so the first power play of the game belongs to the Devils. Special teams here in training camp at preseason games is really a challenge for the coaches. As Bartulis is spilled by Langenbrenner, and, well, this power play doesn't last very long for the Devils. 8 seconds is all as Langenbrenner is going to sit, probably for tripping.
That's what you call a great penalty kill right
there.
Jamie Langenbrenner heads over to the box after tripping up, I believe, Bartulis. Both players going for the puck in behind Michael Layton. And there's Bartulis in the foot of Jamie Langenbrenner, the veteran, taking down the defenseman with the foot. And a good call by the referee. Play a little bit of four-on-four hockey here for the next minute 52.
But as we were saying, special teams, the units aren't set in these games. The lineups don't necessarily allow you to have your full units out there. So this is very much something that a lot of the let will watch when they get to a power play or on the penalty kill. But not going to take too much time with it. It's Carter getting it in front. He scores! Persistence from Jeff Carter as he just stayed with that one and then whacked it out of midair past Hedberg. It's 2-0 Philadelphia. Carter scores for a case of Tasty Cakes.
Jeff Carter doing a nice job in following that puck as he had the puck stuck up in his jersey and then watched it drop to the ice and knocked it in with the stick below the crossbar, making sure he was not going to knock it out of the air too high. And right there, he knocks it down and pushes it forward to his stick, as all great goal scorers do. Carter showing that touch that he's exhibited so far in his career.
Two things happen there. Is that once Hedberg loses sight of the puck, then he's got to actually lose control of where he is in the crease. He spreads the legs, bang, five hole, and Carter takes full advantage of it.
Well, the Flyers, the goals from Powell and Carter, a 2-0 lead, teaming in the only assist on that goal. As we take below 7 minutes to play in this first period. Zubris, they back along to the point. Mirbaum back along for Zubris, and now the rookie. Mirbaum looking, a wrist shot blocked off by Mazaros. And a turnover by Zhirdev, and then a little gimpy after a collision with Zubris. And he's still flexing his left leg, and in fact, is going to head off to the bench.
Yeah, Zubris caught Zhirdev as he came across the middle in the defensive zone, and the former Flyer, Dinis Zubris, catching the inside of Zhirdev's leg.
Meantime, here's Giroux. Dancing his way up ice, turns back, his pass to the point, kept in, they say, by Coburn. Coburn then run at by Brad Mills, and right there is Clarkson to backhand it out, and here is Mills getting to it. Mills, Cetteri, DeCorenti cutting in the shot, and late in the stick save. Back the other way goes Giroux. He's got Van Riemsdyk, but Frazier broke up the pass and went in on goal. And now Van Riemsdyk will recapture for Philadelphia, takes a couple hits. Where all that work of the offseason will pay off for him in those battles along the walls. Giroux comes in. Now O'Donnell, side of the net. Van Riemsdyk waiting. Back in front. Giroux, the shot. Save Hedberg. Good save there by Hedberg as he stayed with Giroux. He gave him the head fake, but goalie wasn't buying it. And those two kids that have grown up rapidly, they got some great experience in those playoffs. And, of course, Giroux was terrific. Here's Guerin moving up. Guerin with a wrist shot. That one bounces wide. There's Nodal after the puck for Powell. And the puck deflecting and finally controlled by Langenbrenner. He'll take a hit from Powell as he gets the puck out to center ice. Pizarro's there. Goes off of Mayer and back in and controlled by Nodal. Picked down toward 5 minutes remaining in this first period. Mo Timonen to Powell. He's run at by Adam Mayer. Another tryout is the former Sabre trying to make this Devils team. And you think he has a chance.
I'm a big fan of Adam Mayer. He plays with a ton of heart. He's a willing guy to step in there and drop the gloves as he's chatting with Jody Shelley right now. And Adam Mayer, one of those guys that's willing to do whatever it takes for his hockey club.
Bilguerin knocked down in center. Popped up the puck. Here's Arnott in the middle. Eliash the shot. And Leighton got just a piece to deflect that one wide. Bilguerin after it again. He'll move it ahead. And Jody Shelley is there to bunt it into the Devil's zone. Shelley hooked, but no call. He'll try to follow up. A little obstruction. I hope that's not a sign they're going to start allowing that, because that was something we haven't seen a lot of in the league over the last 5 years. Shelley trying to get it.
I think we're going to see a whole lot of it. The game's at such a great pace right now.
Exactly.
There's going to be a little bit of that, especially when Jody Shelley's coming in on your D partner. You like to get a piece of him. There's another big hit out there.
And Holmstrom, a rookie for the Flyers, with a good hit. Henrik Tillander, and now Arnott, a shot that's bouncing toward the slot, still swarming toward the net, finally tipped away, and then clanked off the boards to center and down by Shelley, and it runs out of steam, so no icing.
Get a look at the calming influence of Sean O'Donnell in his defensive zone. That puck was bouncing. He just tapped it up to Jody Shelley, allowing the Flyers to make some line changes and get some fresh legs on the ice.
Josephson sending that one across, but it's played by Sheridan. His pass could not be knocked down by Carter. That's Fraser's back for it. Fraser with a pass. Stepping up on the play. The Flyers was teaming in, and now we've got a scrap in the neutral zone. Richards involved. Dinah Zubris. And lots of pushing and shoving now. Dinah Zubris, the former Flyer, going after the current captain. Jeff Carter with persistence here gives the Flyers a 2-0 lead. Another end. Leighton comes up big.
You're looking at one of the emerging young stars in the National Hockey League. Claude Giroux had a very good regular season. He played all 82 games, picked up 47 points, but the playoffs were something to behold. Claude Giroux picked up 21 points in 23 games in the playoffs, and was just a constant contributor to the offensive production for the Flyers. His ice time increased. He scored a huge goal in game 82 in the shootout right there and carried that forward. He had an unbelievable series against the Montreal Canadiens and is looking to carry that confidence forward here this season.
He also, at least just from appearances, is bigger in the upper body. I think he's trying to strengthen himself as well, just as Van Riemsdyk did. The current Miners roughing on Zubris, slashing on Richards. And here are the Devils with a shot by Toledo. Deflection score! That one deflected in front, perhaps by Mayer. He had his stick in there. And so the Devils on the board. It's a 2-1 hockey game.
Big blast from the point with traffic in front. Oscars Bartoulis was tied up with Adam Mayer. Not sure if Mayer got a stick on that blast from the point, but there's the heads-up play by Tillander to his former teammate Mayer in Buffalo. Adam Mayer puts it in.
Well, Tillander is a pretty good defenseman, but that's not exactly the best shot to be able to deflect, but Mayer stood right there, got real good hands to be able to get that stick up in the air and coordinate the redirection. Bartoulis completely defenseless, and Leighton certainly defenseless in that situation also.
Devils coming right back in, and Arnott a shot that went wide. Well, if you want to try to make a team, you're in a tryout. Getting a goal certainly doesn't hurt your cause, and Adam Mayer, no more for his, as you mentioned earlier, his effort and his physical play, is on the board here. Tillander and Urbom get the assists at 16:54. So a 2-1 hockey game. There's Salvador going it along. Tillander and Anton Volchenkov, the two big additions on defense for the Devils during the offseason. Volchenkov not playing tonight. They lost Paul Martin from that defense score. But those are two real good players. Tillander last year paired with the Rookie of the Year in the National Hockey League, Tyler Myers, and they feel as though his steadying influence had something to do with Myers taking home that hardware.
Yeah, and both he and Volchenkov, two guys that are consistently plus players and have been very good in that department through their careers. Volchenkov, a great shot blocker. Tillander, a terrific skater and a good defender, has a real nice job of cutting angles down and I think the Devils are going to be real happy with those two additions.
One thing the Sabres always talked about was Foligno's ability to be able to get that first pass out of the zone. Big, tall, lanky guy with a great skating ability, but boy, he can really pass it.
Oh, big hit on Josefsson, and that's going to be a penalty. Coburn going to go. And the Flyers unable to touch the puck edge yet, so a delayed call as Clarkson muscling behind the net, able to keep O'Donnell away from it, and now Mayer jumps to it. They're getting it back to the point. Shot Fraser, and that one sails high and wide all the way out to Correnti. And Correnti, who played up front during the playoffs last year for the Devils against the Flyers, dumps it in along the wall. Clarkson, good play to get it back to Fraser. Still a delayed call here. Pass across. Josefsson could not come up with that, and now O'Donnell will. And there's your whistle. Coburn will go to the sin bin.
Braden Coburn aggressive in the defensive zone. Got a little too much of Josefsson there. We've saved you a seat. Take home a piece of history with two Spectrum chairs and enjoy live hockey action with two lower-level Flyers tickets at the Wells Fargo Center for select games. A great value, only $200. Call 215-218-PUCK, or you can visit PhiladelphiaFlyers.com to get yours today. And when you're here at the Wells Fargo Center, you can see some physical play. You don't want the trip, though, as Braden Coburn gets got there and then has a little bit of a hit from behind on Josefsson and draws the penalty.
And it was the second one that got the penalty, boarding the call. There's Matt Walker moving up on the play for the Flyers. They're shorthanded. Walker around behind the Devils' net. Just tucking it back around the other way to waste some time off the clock. Into the final minute of this first period. A 2-1 Flyers lead. Devils trying to tie it with a man advantage. Andy Green pushing that ahead to Patrick Elias. Elias maneuvering on in, then tried to drop it back. Didn't get enough on the pass, but it does stay in the zone. And now Elias has it back to Arnott. Out to Green. And now it's Arnott. Down low, Langenbrenner in front to Linder, but he could not handle that pass cleanly out of his skate. Green has it across for Arnott. He has a heavy shot. Flips one down low, Langenbrenner. Langenbrenner getting it back out in front. Green shot high and wide. Behind the net, Elias able to fish it free. His pass to Arnott, 18 seconds in the period. Green a shot, batted away calmly by Layton. And Holmstrom trying to clear, second try, he will.
Michael Layton looking good in goal there, using that blocker to redirect that puck into a safe area, allowing this defense and forwards to track that puck down and send it down the ice.
And that's it for period number one. Flyers with a 2-1 lead through 20 minutes of play. And tonight's Flyers-Devils first period was brought to you by McDonald's. Eat, sleep, and drink orange at McDonald's with an Arctic orange milkshake. It's the real taste of oranges in a thick, creamy milkshake. Get fired up at McDonald's. I'm loving it. Downstairs we go to Coatsy. And we're having a little difficulty with Coatsy's mic, so we'll try to get back to him later. 2-1 Flyers after one. One period in the books, and this portion of Flyers hockey is brought to you by your local Chevrolet dealers. 2-1 Flyers through 20 minutes of play here at Wells Fargo Center. Have I been all right with that so far?
Yeah, you're doing
all
well, buddy.
Okay.
Here they go.
Well, you know what we do when you look at the very first preseason game, it's always fun, of course, to see all the guys on the ice for the first time this year. But in particular, your eyes go to the newcomers, the guys you haven't seen before, whether it be a rookie like Ben Holmstrom or some of the guys who've been around a little bit like Nikolaj Zhertev.
Yeah, Zhertev getting a great opportunity in this game, as he will in this Flyers lineup, playing with Jeff Carter and Mike Richards. Carter playing the right side. Zhertev showing how smart he is in the offensive zone. He got a couple of opportunities in tight, and you can just see the puck come his way. And he's got that great hockey sense, and the Flyers are really hoping to bring that back to the table. Nikolaj Zhertev had a couple of off seasons before he left to go to the KHL. Took a lot of heat in Columbus as a guy that wasn't willing to pay the extra price. Give him a chance. Mm-hmm. Let's see what he can do around some real character players here in Philadelphia. And this team has gained a ton of experience from the playoff run last year. Their leadership core is even a year older now. Guys like Captain Mike Richards, a guy that's playing with Zhertev in this game tonight. And I think he's in a pretty good position to be real successful here.
Well, one of the character guys you talk about is Bill Guerin, who's trying out to make the team. So you got Zhertev and Guerin, two of the newcomers that we're certainly watching. And so is head coach Peter Laviolette.
Well, Zhirinov comes in, and you know, I think it's a great opportunity to try and pick up some of the offense that you lose with a guy like Simone. He's proven to have been a goal scorer in other teams, point getter. He's a Rangers leading scorer. He left. He goes to the KHL for a year. He's back. He wants back in the NHL. This could be a good fit for him in our organization with our players playing the style that we play. You know, you need to get those guys that can put the puck in the back of the net and make plays, and he's certainly one of those guys that can do that. You know, Billy Guerin comes here with a great attitude, a lot of experience, and looking for an opportunity. You know, he's in terrific shape. He looks great on the ice in practice so far in camp. He's going to play some games. I understand he's a veteran player, but in the same sense, we want to give him an opportunity to show what he can do and how he fits in on our team, so he'll play some games for us.
You have to figure this training camp, the first time in Bill Guerin's career that he's got to step it up in the preseason to make a real impression. But he showed a lot in the first period. I know he's looking forward to challenging to be on this Flyers team. And like we talked about earlier, I would not be surprised at all to see him as a Flyer this season.
Overall, good period for the Flyers. They lead 2-1. When we come back, you meet the new reporter, Comcast Sportsnet, covering the Flyers, Lisa Hillary. There's your score through 20 minutes of play in preseason game number one for the Philadelphia Flyers. And Jonesy, it's great to be back. Great to be covering the Flyers again. I mean, that run last year was so exciting, and we're certainly excited to be bringing Flyers hockey to the Delano Valley again this year.
Yeah, there was great expectations on the Flyers team last year. The Hockey News had picked them to win the Stanley Cup. Regular season was not terrific. They got in on game 82 in a shootout. I expect this regular season to be a lot different. They added a lot of character players now to go with that mix and young nucleus. That's another year of experience into the National Hockey League. So look for good things from this Flyers team in a very difficult division, but they've put themselves in a pretty good position to be successful.
Well, you know, the Flyers, yes, they have some additions to their team. We have an addition to our team here covering the Flyers as well. She's downstairs right now with Steve Coates.
Thank you very much, Jimmy, and it's my pleasure to introduce our new addition here at Comcast Sportsnet as the hockey reporter for the Philadelphia Flyers, Lisa Hillary, and welcome to Philadelphia.
Thanks very much, Coatesy. It's been wonderful. A good couple of weeks so far, and it's been a bit of a transition, but all is going well so far.
You came over from the Washington Capitals, a pretty exciting team in their own right, but you're now coming to a team that went to the Stanley Cup Finals. That's got to be exciting for you.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, just the fan support. Of course, the other night we did the Meet the Flyers and everybody came out. The fans have just embraced me, absolutely, from the moment I got here, and the guys as well. I sat down with Briere last week for a good half hour and getting to know him, and sitting down with Chris Pronger tomorrow, really looking forward to that.
In the short period of time, you've had an opportunity to diagnose this hockey club. What are you looking forward to?
I'm looking forward to seeing how the whole defense shapes up. Of course, Chris Pronger is still out right now. We don't know. We're hoping he's going to be back, of course, for that first game. But with eight defensemen, you've got to think somebody's going to go. And we've seen something out of Matt Walker tonight. I just said to you, some pretty expensive $1.6 million hands right there, doing his best to obviously show the coaches what he's got.
Well, Lisa, welcome to Philadelphia. We look for a great year from you, and we look forward to having a lot of fun. And on that note, Jimmy, back up to you.
All right, Coatesy, thank you very much. Certainly, we'd like to welcome Lisa to our team as well. Should be a great year covering the Flyers, as we talked about. Let's look at some of the highlights from period number one here tonight, Jones.
Yeah, pretty busy first period. The Flyers picking up a goal by Darryl Powell there. Some good work by Claude Giroux, and the rebound by Johan Hedberg goes right to Powell, who puts it in. And again, Jeff Carter driving to the front of that, following the bouncing puck, and he puts it to the legs of Johan Hedberg as well. Michael Layton, a couple of saves in the period, and that was on Matt Corinthy, who jumped up, and there's the goal by Adam Mayer from his former Sabre teammate Henrik Tillander. So a couple of goals for the Flyers and one for the Devils after the first period.
There is your scoring summary as Powell, Carter, and Mayer light the lamp. Solid period indeed for Michael Layton. Had no chance in the goal and made some good stops with traffic around him in that first period. We're closing in on second period action here at the Wells Fargo Center. Back in a moment. Tonight's second period from the Wells Fargo Center is brought to you by Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you. And by your Quality Plus Ford stores. Just about set for the start of second period action here. The Flyers holding a 2-1 lead. Devils out shooting Philadelphia 12-9 in period number one.
Michael Layton looking pretty sharp in goal, and the Devils have their big line in this game out on the ice. Jason Arnott, of course, back in the fold with New Jersey after spending some time with the Dallas Stars, where he was a key contributor, and then with the Nashville Predators over the last few seasons. Played just 63 games last year with numerous injuries, and the Devils are hoping he has a real healthy, productive season for them once again.
Andy Green penetrating the Philadelphia zone. Devils still on the power play with Coburn off and that boarding minor. And Green could not go back into the zone there. Would have been offside, so he handles now at his own line. 16 seconds remaining on that power play. Talinder harassed, but able to move away from Ian LaPerriere and finds Arnett. Arnett worked down by Bartulis, drops it back to Green. All the way across Talinder. He'll wind and fire gloved by Layton. No further play.
Let's take a look inside the game as Henrik Talinder tried another high shot on Michael Layton. Layton comes up with the save there, as he did on 11 Devil shots in the first period. Devils picking up one goal on 12 shots. The Flyers with nine shots picked up two goals. Power play opportunities. The Devils going 0 for 2, and one of those was just 8 seconds. And the Flyers going 0 for 1 on their short power play chance.
Braden Coburn exits the penalty box just as they're announcing that he's been given an assist. And the Flyer goal in that first period, the Jeff Carter tally. So Coburn has himself a point. Here's Carter with the puck. The shot! Save Hedberg. Rebound was right there, but the Devils able to take care of it as Fraser backhanded out of harm's way. Josephson across. Parenti checked by Zhirdev. Surging to that is Carter. And now it's Parenti taking over, and he'll flip across for Fraser. Fraser's outlet pass bounces off of Richards, gathered by Mazaros, but the Devils have it back, and Clarkson will feather it ahead, hoping for Zubris, found Thiemann in instead. And now Zhirdev, the long pass out to Carter. And Carter will float one in. Hedberg will drop that one down. Johan Hedberg, signed by the Devils, is a free agent. The question is, how many games will he play?
I'm going to say 15. How about 15? Marty Brodeur gets a little bit of a rest.
Yeah.
But John McLean, the new head coach of the Devils, very familiar with what Brodeur is capable of doing.
Marcus Nielsen all the way around. Tried to set her, blocked off, gets it back. Nielsen trying to fight off the checking of Braden Coburn, and now gets some help with the puck rolling free. Mayer run at by Walker. This is more of that physical play from the former Lightning defender as the Flyers get it out to center. Guerin couldn't corral that bouncing puck as he was looking to step ahead. Shunov now has it. He's checked. Oh, an offsides call. Guerin was still getting out of the zone as Briere touched the puck.
You know, when Mike Richards originally drafted back in 2003, they all talked about he was going to be the future. He was very much like Bob Clark in the way he played the game. He was a natural leader. He brought it every night. And boy, I'll tell you, when he scores goals, boy, a lot of them are pretty goals. And he's just so smart with the puck, knows when to feed it, knows when to give it up. How about this one against Montreal last year where he goes by Halak and then all of a sudden has the composure to get up, look at and see the puck and put it into the open net. That's Mike Richards, and that's why he's the captain of this hockey club.
We'll all remember that goal for a long time. You'll get to see Halak in the second game of the season, not in St. Louis. How surprised you were that the Canadiens moved Halak and kept Price.
Shocking, really. Halak was so fantastic last year in the Canadiens' surprise playoff run, knocking off the Penguins and the Washington Capitals before losing in 5 games to the Flyers. And Halak obviously had a tremendous year, and I believe he's going to continue to move forward with the St. Louis Blues. A great pickup for the Blues.
Alexander Urbom deposited on the ice by Claude Giroux, and the Flyers come up with the puck. Giroux throwing it out in center, hoping for Zhirdev. He dove after the puck, not as a result of a check, could not come up with it. And now Kimmo Timonen has it. Loose glove on the ice. And that belonged to Mazaros. He's getting that back as the Flyers move up the ice. And Richards will dump it in. You never want to see a player performing without the glove, but especially in a preseason game. You just don't want that slash to happen. Here's Arnott busting up the middle and on goal, and he fired it wide. Eliash run off the play by Carter, but they couldn't clear the zone. Richards tried to stay with it, does have the puck now, and finds Mazara. And to Zhirdev, moving laterally, and then the pass to Richards. Richards slamming on the brakes, holds on, tried to feather that one back. It's swatted at by Walker, but gotten back by the Devils, and they'll move to center. Jamie Langenbrenner will wind up and blast. The save by Layton. The rebound back toward Langenbrenner, but Coburn gets there first.
Prime scoring chance there for Jason Arnott. He'll be the second-line centerman for the New Jersey Devils behind Travis Zajac. And the Devils, of course, not dressing their top line. They have practice together. Ilya Kovalchuk moving to the right side, and Zach Parise on the left side. That's a ton of goals on that line. And this Devils team is going to be very formidable this season, and Arnott will be a key factor in that.
John McClain, the first-year head coach, deciding to make that move. Here's Zubris, a backhander that goes wide. Play taking over for Jacques Lemaire. Here's Fraser with that shot that dribbles wide. And Travis Zajac in the middle is saying, some people were saying, you know, you're not really going to see the puck. You probably won't get 100 shots all year. And McClain's answer, he'll get 100 assists. Here's Urban moving up for the shot. Save made by Layton. Michael Layton has been good in this game. Briere trying to maneuver. He could not get around Josephson. And the Flyers have it back. Coburn, quick pass in the middle. And pitched into the zone by the Flyers. Van Riemsdyk, but offside is called.
Kyle Jason Arnott comes over, and he's a former Devil. But watch this. Now, he's a right-hand shot. You figure, oh, he's going to go to the left of Layton. He actually tries to get him the other way and go off that far pipe. And look at this. Layton has been strong. See where he didn't move. He didn't move. He's solid in there. He's not overplaying the puck. He's playing the shooter and just doing a real nice job and not getting too much movement in that goaltending area. And he just looks so confident.
Well, that's the key. You know how the season ended last year. He had a great run, but the goal had won it for the Blackhawks. Everyone wanted to ask Michael about it during the offseason. He told me, yeah, I thought about it a lot. But once I'm back out on the ice, that is history. It's got to be out of my mind. And good to see him playing so well here in his first game back.
Yeah, and having the offseason to get back in great condition. He, remember, battled back from injuries and stepped back into the net during the playoffs. And you have to wonder if he was 100% during that playoff run, but he sucked it up for the team and came up with some real strong performances.
And he got a contract out of it. And was noted with some good work for the Flyers as they try to build something offensively. Bartulis' shot, save Hedberg as Shelley tried to get there for redirection. Now Giroux has it. Giroux looking in front, looking for Shelley then, but Mayer had him tied up. Good job of back checking there. Bartulis shuffling that one aside for Shelley. Shelley, a wrist shot, hit a body in front. Hedberg came over to knock it away if it had gotten through, and now it flips back out to center ice. But Layton was saying, I mean, his confidence certainly helped by the fact that the Flyers gave him that contract in the offseason, despite the way it ended. They showed confidence in him.
Yeah, well-deserved contract for Michael Layton, and Flyers looking forward to having him in the fold for a full season. It's Peter Laviolette's first full year, and ooh, Michael Layton's first opportunity to start the season with the Flyers.
Big hit by Ian LaPerriere on Brad Mills. And then some more contact as Shelley came together with Bryce Salvador. Now the Flyers have the puck. Holmstrom had his back turn, couldn't get that puck out of the zone. Layton will steer it along. Shelley trying to force that one out. He gets hit by LeBlanc. Those two could certainly see each other and have the gloves fall at some point this game as Bartulis now settles things down. Just about 7 minutes into the second period. Coburn and Bartulis play catch, and then it's into the Devil zone.
Well, it's interesting you said that about Shelley because, you know, Shelley came over from the Western Conference, so you've got to introduce yourself to all the tough guys in the Eastern Conference. Is that not correct? So he's had the opportunity to have a conversation with LeBlanc, had an opportunity to talk to Clarkson, and he's just moving himself around to be able to make sure that he has that ability to be able to just have a little conversation with everybody before he leaves here tonight.
And he had a chance at the tail end of last season to do that after coming over from San Jose to the Rangers, but just a few games under his belt.
Mostly
the
a
Westerner,
yeah. Devils and Rangers probably did play, but it might have been to the point of the season where you had to really pick your fights carefully. Here's Carter moving on up for Philadelphia. Carter swerving to the middle. And then the pass back makes its way through to Richards, but a swing and a miss. And they puck back up. Zubris, nice little pass to Correnti. Now Clarkson. Clarkson looking to get it back to Correnti. Save, Layton, rebound on Zubris. Shot, he scores! What a shot from Dinas Zubris. As he jumped on that loose puck, beats Layton, and this game is tied at two.
Some people wonder if Dinas Zubris will be the odd man out with the Devils being over the salary cap right now, and Zubris looking to have a full season with the Devils. He missed 30 games last year with a leg injury, but that's what he can do when he gets those opportunities. A quick wrist shot there beats Michael Layton.
Well, that's a good shot. And you know what? He's had a lot of success against the Flyers since he left the Flyers, former number one pick of the Philadelphia Flyers, came out of Tier 2 Junior A to jump into the National Hockey League. Unbelievable. But boy, he's a big man, guys. And he's played very well for the Devils. It'll be interesting to see what they do.
Zuby now 32 years of age. Can you believe that, Coatsy?
Yeah, you had to bring that up, right?
Where does time go? Yeah. Remember, as an 18-year-old.
Yeah.
There he is with the puck. He was almost that big as an 18-year-old.
That was huge.
That's made him amazing.
Played over 900 games in the National Hockey League now. It's something to see. A lot of great seasons with the Washington Capitals as well. A little short stint with the Buffalo Sabres. And he's found a nice home with the Devils so far.
Michael Josefsson navigating his way into the Philadelphia zone. He's a young player, but Devils very high on Josefsson. Also high on this guy, Erbom. He couldn't keep the puck in, though. Now it's back to Josefsson.
Erbom having the opportunity to play with Henrik Tillander, much like you mentioned earlier, Tyler Myers did with the Buffalo Sabres last year, and Erbom picked up an assist on the first Devils goal in this game by Adam Mayer. Tillander picking up an assist on that goal as well. And Oscar Bartulis does a good job hustling back for that icing. There's Dinas Zubras looking to pick up some numbers this year for the New Jersey Devils. A very steady performer, a guy that can play physical as well, strong on the puck in the offensive zone, and does a nice job in battling for rebounds when he's on top of his game. And Lou Lamoriello and John McClain looking for a lot of that from Dinas Zubras. He's on a nice contract there with the Devils. But again, they do have to move a player to make some room. And
3 to 5 million over the cap right now. No one will give an exact amount. Penfield's closer to three. Here's Giroux, centering. That one bounces back at Clarkson. Will just stab it out through center. Race for the puck here. Shunov will get to it, and then he's wrestled to the wall before Clarkson picks it up.
I think Kovalchuk might have had a little bit to do with that cap problem. If I had said
like
to you
everything
guys,
to do with it.
Yeah, if I had said to you two gentlemen last year that the New Jersey Devils would give Ilya Kovalchuk a long-term contract, what would you have said to me?
I honestly would not have been surprised.
You wouldn't have?
Nope, just based upon the fact that they went out and traded for him, and, you know, Lou doesn't get very many things wrong, and Ilya Kovalchuk was a player that stepped into the Devils system and was willing to be a part of it, and a lot of people question whether or not it was a smart move, but you get that feeling that Lou's going to make sure that it was a smart move, and Kovalchuk a very capable player. If you want affordable luxury, you can do it right here. Watch Flyers hockey action from a Wells Fargo Center suite. Suites can accommodate up to 24 people and offer incredible food options, wait service, and private restrooms. Affordable luxury is only a call or click away. Call 215-389-9500, or you can visit mypremiumtix.com. John McClain applauding on the bench there. This guy is moving.
45 years of age. Last year, the head coach, Lowell, American Hockey League, longtime assistant for the Devils, and their all-time leading goal scorer. He was part of their cup team in 95. He's talking about moving Kovalchuk to the right side. That's a pretty interesting move for a rookie head coach. Nazarov's a pass across, and then the shot goes wide. Nazarov, trying to set up Holmstrom there, but Holmstrom could not get that one on net as the puck might have been rolling a little bit, one of those long passes. Now Holmstrom doing the work in his own zone. Ben Holmstrom, 43 years of age, from Colorado Springs. The puck to the point. Parenti's shot goes wide. Nazarov battling in the corner. Back out it goes to the point. Fraser, a shot. That goes through a maze of sticks and skates wide. And the Devils have the Flyers pinned in the zone a little bit here. The Flyers get to it here. And they'll move up 9 minutes, a little less than that remaining here in this second period. Zaros just floating that out to center. That's a turnover. Aliash will jump on it. Patrick Aliash moving it in, centering. That's tipped away, bounces back. Ready, shot, save, Leighton rebound. Arnott, shot, save, Leighton, another shot. Leighton got there again. Michael Leighton with some good stops in tight, and now the Flyers in the counter rush. Carter kicking it out of his skates, moving up. His pass is tipped away. Ready, getting back to it. And now Hedberg decides to jump at the puck at the side of his net. 8.5 remaining, second period. Deuces are wild.
Well, Michael Leighton and I talk about how solid he looked. And look at this save he's going to make. Now, original shot, big shot from right in the slider. That's a wind up and let her go. And there's the rebound. Not one, but two rebounds. And watch Leighton very, very quietly, very subtly. He never lost sight of the puck. And then all of a sudden, the last second, that puck came flying up and he got the glove on it. But his idea of moving very casually across, not overplaying it, that's the key to the whole thing. And he never, never changed his body position. His upper torso was up, giving him a good look at that puck.
Yeah, sometimes I think that almost works against him because his saves don't look spectacular, but those right there, that was a great sequence. You know, he moved just enough, pushing off, as Coatsy was talking about, to get in position to handle those rebounds. Made the stops.
It was a more flamboyant save. You know, the fans and everybody noticed it more.
And it was Matt Corrente jumping in again on the Devils' blue line and firing that quick shot. And as you mentioned earlier, he played forward for the Devils in the playoffs, but he'll be back on the point this season. And twice in this game, he's jumped up in the offensive zone.
Here's Talinder blasting one save late, but this time he gives up the rebound, and it's rammed home. Jamie Langenbrenner in front as he was going to the ice. Pounds it home, and the Devils have scored three in a row and have a 3-2 lead here with 7:54 to play in the second.
Well, Henrik Talinder not known for a lot of points, but he's doing a nice job in this game. He picks up his second assist. The Flyers unable to get that puck cleared, and Talinder walks in and lets another high shot go. This time Michael Layton has the rebound bounce to the stick of Jamie Langenbrenner, and Langenbrenner puts it into the goal.
Well, the key here is the puck hits him high. Now, he's looking for it by the time he finds it, because watch the puck come out to the right and then go kicks over. It kicks over to Langenbrenner. Langenbrenner then has the ability, as he's on the forehand, to fire through the five hole. But you can just see the skate of another Devil player right in the slot area, kicking that over to Langenbrenner.
So Mayer, Zubris, and Langenbrenner with the unanswered goals to this point, and the Devils have their first lead of the game, 3-2. And they have certainly stepped it up. Josephson with a pass for Zubris. He's denied by Coburn. Josephson gets it back. Roll that one deep into the Philadelphia zone. Van Riemsdyk over after it. Run at hard by Clarkson. Back to Walker, and now it's Van Riemsdyk again. He's just going to float this one out to center as he's run at again. Here's Guerin in center, turning with it. His pass to Briere. Briere and across the line. Lays it off for Coburn for a shot that was well off the target. Now here's Van Riemsdyk getting back to it. Around behind Briere. Briere stops, changes direction. Salvador shoves him. Briere still has it. His pass for Powell. His wrist is blocked. Back it goes. Now the centering pass off Guerin at the side of the net. Guerin back after it, trying to fight off a check. Guerin has a look around. Out of the back end, it's blocked. Rebound. Powell, a crack at it. He could not get it on goal, and Guerin then denied in front, and the Devils clear.
See some good puck protection from Bill Guerin down the offensive zone, blocking the Devils defender from getting to that loose puck and setting Darryl Powell up for a shot towards the goal.
Fraser after the puck in the corner. Giroux in there as well. Oh, Giroux showing some of that tenacity. The puck rolls free to Fraser. And he'll send it off his stick. Shunov's stick out to center ice. Bartulis for Giroux. Go Giroux in again. That's on in, then turns back with it. Giroux with a pass back, and then the shot by Tiemannin. Bound glass, as you probably heard, as well as saw. And now back up. He was trying to get that puck to Mazaros, but it never got there. And now the scrum along the wall, and it's Powell dumping it deep into the Devil's zone. Less than six to play here in the second period. Devils three, Flyers two. Tiemannin just sends that one in along as the Flyers need to change players. Fraser ahead to Mayer. Mayer will twist it in along the left wing board. Mazaros back. Puck bounces free. Oh, big hit on Holmstrom by Mills. Now trying to dance up with it is LaPerriere. He is checked. Shelley came over and had a word or two for Mills after that hit on Holmstrom. And this is icing on New Jersey. Email, text, Twitter, and Facebook 24/7. CSNPhilly.com is your most complete source for the latest news and the Flyers return to the ice. The Phillies drive for another division title and on the Eagles as they prepare for the Jags. Text alerts to 53695. Or sign up for alerts at csnphilly.com.
Ben Holmstrom out to take this faceoff against the guy that just hit him in the neutral zone. Brad Mills wins the draw. And Holmstrom, another one of those young guys, signed as a free agent out of University of Mass. And is a guy that can really add something to the offensive side of things, but is a very intelligent player at both ends of the ice. Brings a little physical element to the game as well.
Now with four games in 5 days, eight preseason games overall, we're going to see, or at least the coaching staff's going to see, some of those college kids that were signed last March. Is that shot handled by Leighton, who then gets chopped at as Mills stirring things up again. Walker follows him all the way to the corner. LeBlond is in there. And we have some animosity. And quite dying down finally, perhaps. Jamie Langenbrenner, the captain of the Devils, has given them their first lead of the game. We'll be back.
just a few days into training camp, and Flyers Devils hockey already started. Some good rough stuff going on. Jody Shelley, Pierre-Luc LeBlanc getting into it there. Flyers hockey is back. Opening week of the Flyers regular season in Philadelphia begins Monday, October the 11th versus Colorado. All fans will receive a replica Eastern Conference Championship banner and schedule magnet presented by Toyota. For tickets, you can call 800-298-4200 or visit PhiladelphiaFlyers.com. That is just around the corner, and the Avalanche, much improved last year, will be a team that's looking to move forward again this season.
Zhirinov with a pass to Carter. He had that puck bounce on him just as he was trying to tee it up. Now Zhirinov ridden down by Langenbrunner. Yeah, the Devils have it back. And we get ahead for Eliash. Eliash having a little difficulty locating it. And Zhirinov will take it off his hands. 4:30 remaining in this second period. Carter has to go off his skate to Richards. Richards, the pass through. Tiiminen. Tiiminen trying to center, blocked. Around behind the net, the Devils gain control. Here's Henrik Tallinder. Head for Eliash in the middle. Arnott right back to Eliash. He'll bounce one in. It's fended off by Layton. Into the corner. Crowd trying to get the Flyers going here. They scrum forward in the corner. Clarkson drops it back in along. He tried to center it for Arnott. It never made it. And now it's Carter. Rinsdijk trying to catch up with that, but it's Bryce Salvador instead to Clarkson. Quickly ahead now for Zubris. Dinah Zubris given some room, then tried to flip one. That was blocked by Bartulis. Bounces back to Clarkson, and now Salvador. His pass knocked down by Guerin. And then O'Donnell trying to spring Guerin. It's Guerin and Salvador. And Guerin's shot blocked off by Salvador and goes into the safety netting. 3:34 to play here in the second.
Well, these teams have never really liked each other, and I know it's the first preseason game, but still, with some new people in both lineups, they're trying to make a name for themselves. Jody Shelley, his first time in the lineup, and there's been some great body checks. Then LeBlanc and Walker went at it early in the first period, so pushing and shoving after that last try on Layton. As you see, Matt Walker, the newcomer for the Philadelphia Flyers, has really shown a presence here this evening with both the fisticuffs and taking the body.
Liked hearing Walker's reaction to his trade. He said, at first I was stunned, then I heard where I was going and realized that ever since I was a kid, he had a little soft spot in his heart for the Flyers because that's his style of play. Thought it would be a good fit, so he didn't stay shocked very long. He said it turned to excitement rather quickly.
Friends and family were fired up for him to get an opportunity to play for the Philadelphia Flyers, and Matt Walker showing the fans here in the first preseason game that he likes the physical side of that game of hockey, and the fans here in Philadelphia have a tendency to enjoy that.
This will be icing on the Flyers as Salvador is back for the touch-up. Peter Laviolette looking on. He really uses training camp in terms of the practices for conditioning and systems. He said really in terms of evaluation, you got to get him in games for the most part.
Yeah, and he's getting a look here, and obviously the Flyers have picked it up since the Devils took the 3-2 lead. I thought the intensity level had kind of got to a little bit of a lull there for about 10 minutes. A big hit here by Fraser, and the Flyers will look to build on that as Danny Briere comes back and sticks up for his teammate on the ice, Bill Guerin.
How about that?
That's what you're looking for.
Danny Briere coming to the aid of Bill Guerin as that puck deflects out of play just into the safety netting. Of course, we saw, and we've known about it, the feistiness, that side of Danny Briere's play. We saw a lot of it in the playoffs last year.
And we saw a lot of production from Danny Briere in the playoffs last year. There's the hit by Fraser on Bill Guerin, and there's Danny Briere coming to let Fraser know that he's not going to take that here at the Wells Fargo Center. And Fraser's still on the ice. I'm not going to keep him off the ice the way that he takes a check.
Remember, Fraser was inserted into the series last year, and it's a move. Jacques Lemaire surprised a lot of people with it. An experienced defenseman, and he struggled. Flyers centering pass there. That one for Giroux, but it went on through to Coburn, and his shot is blocked aside. Ready ahead. And now it's picked up by Mayer. Adam Mayer with a drop pass. Schoenhoff didn't expect that. He's been swarmed upon by a couple of Flyers to get the puck to center ice. 2:15 remaining here in this second period. A pass off a stick and then a skate. Batted ahead by Nielsen. Schoenhoff
checked by Coburn. And now it comes back out. Urbom looking it along for Nielsen. He'll turn with it, hold, give some room, and then center, and it went off of Ishunov, wide of the net. A bit of a break down there, but the Flyers get away with it. Nodal then trying to clear, and he does. Powell trying to move up through center with it, but he was checked by Ishunov. Kalinder, Mayer, and he'll just sweep it into the Philadelphia zone. Devils have outshot the Flyers 11-4 here in this second period. Pass ahead to Ian LaPerriere. He's pass behind Holmstrom, but he'll turn it deep into the Devils' zone. The Moose, Johan Hedberg sets it up there for Talinder. And the lanky defenseman moves up. Rink wide for LeBlanc. He'll shovel it deep to Philadelphia ice. Waiten is out. He's got some company back there. Turns it over. Good play by Holmstrom there as he cut off the Devils at the pass. There was an empty net. Now Mills. Brad Mills twisting and turning in the corner. Around behind the net. Well, there he tried to center that one. Now he's taken away, and Holmstrom has it for Philadelphia. And he'll clear the zone. Into the final minute of this second period. Worked there by Shelley to get to that putt. No icing, but the Devils emerge with the puck. Talinder again rushing to center ice. They say the play is onside. It goes off the team and then covered by Leighton. Well, coming up in between periods two and three, our first segment of Big Mouths. We'll talk about some of the newcomers to the Philadelphia Flyers. We being Mr. Jones, Mr. Coates, and Mr. Chris Therrien from the radio side. As we'll discuss that, talk about keys to success for the Flyers this year. We'll also break this game down. I have highlights and analysis for you all coming up between periods two and three.
Always nice when we have Bundy stop by for a little visit and supply us with that vast knowledge that he has.
He doesn't have opinions, though. He has to force his opinions out.
You know? He's got some strong opinions, doesn't he?
he has the courage of his conviction, right?
Yes, he does.
There's Oscars Bartulis tied up. Must be early in the season. That was just nice to Bundy.
Yeah.
What's with that?
That will not last.
Yeah, no. Not quite, not quite in mid-season form regarding that.
No.
Salvador with 6 seconds remaining in the period. Out ahead, it bounces off to Arnott, and he decides not to take one last shot as the period ends. Good period for the Devils as they go from behind to in front of this game, scoring the only two goals. They outshoot the Flyers 11-4. They have a 3-2 lead through 40 minutes of play. And tonight's Flyers-Devils second period was brought to you by the Pennsylvania Lottery. Benefits older Pennsylvanians every day. Must be 18 or older to play. Please play responsibly. Big Mouse comes at you right after these messages. Welcome back. There's your score through two periods at the Wells Fargo Center. Beautiful look at Center City. It's time for another segment of Big Mouths. Our first broadcast of the year. So, of course, our first segment of Big Mouths. Keith Jones, Chris Therrien, Steve Coates joining me. We'll discuss the Flyers training camp underway, just 3 days old, and some newcomers for the Flyers. Five of them, in fact, most of them playing tonight. And, guys, which newcomer, and we'll start with you, Coates, do you think will have the biggest impact on the team?
Well, first of all, I love your goatee. Don't you agree? I think he looks
very, very nice.
Trying to look mean. There's so many different elements. You'd like to see better defense, obviously. I mean, when you can fill in that 5 and 6 spot. But I'm going to go with Nikolaj Zhurdev. Because you lose Simone Gagné, because you lose that kind of goal scoring, you need somebody to fill that void. Now, did they admit that they went out and took a flyer on Nikolaj Zhurdev? Yes, they did. But if this guy gets back to where he was, now he's over 20 goals 3 years with Columbus and the New York Rangers. He can score goals. So if they can get something from him, that'll be a plus.
I'm going to go easily right now with Andre Mazaros. I think the depth that the Philadelphia Flyers have been able to fill, the void that they had kind of lost last year in the Stanley Cup playoffs, it was evident that the fifth and sixth defenseman was a little bit of a problem as they were trying to find matchups. I think Mazaros comes in. He's going to need to revamp where he was from where his play in Tampa Bay, but if he gets back to the way he played earlier in his career, he's going to be a great fit on defense for the Flyers blue line.
Another guy on defense, obviously Sean O'Donnell, great experience, a veteran player, won a Stanley Cup as Chris Pronger's partner with the Anaheim Ducks. Ducks. A lot of experience back there, but a great guy. I think another great character addition to the dressing room. He is going to have a major influence back there. He played 17, 18 minutes a game for Los Angeles last year. I think he's going to be a guy that really adds a lot of punch on the back end, but also a lot of intelligence. Will have a major impact with the Flyers.
And of course, there's Bill Guerin, who hasn't made the team yet, but if he does, I think he'll have an impact as well. So it'll be very interesting to see how they all mix in with the group. And, you know, speaking of that, four centers really for the top three center ice positions. Is that a positive or a negative, guys?
I think it's a huge positive. I think there's going to be some juggling that goes on, even within games, seeing who's hot as far as winning faceoffs. That may be an influence for Peter Laviolette on who plays more at center ice. Jeff Carter, Mike Richards, obviously two extremely talented center icemen. Claude Giroux emerged last year in the playoffs and really showed what his abilities are. So it's a great challenge for Laviolette to keep these guys happy and continue to move them forward. But at the same time, having those options, especially with injuries the way they occur during the National Hockey League season, it's a real big plus to have a lot of centermen.
I think it shows what a great guy Danny Briere was to have played the wing for the better part of 3 years. Didn't say a word about it. Gets an opportunity to play center. Last year, his natural position when he came from Buffalo, what they signed him for, he was unbelievable. Giroux, as Jonesy said, he's emerging. Here's the one scenario the Flyers are going to have, though. They love the size at center. They always have a la Keith Primo, Eric Lindros. Jeff Carter right now looks like he may just be being the one tweeted over on the right wing right now. I think you may see him go back to the middle with that size asset for the Flyers.
All right, guys, we have less than a minute left. I'm going to ask you for your keys to the season. We'll start with you, Coatsy.
Well, I think the goaltending position. I love the way we filled in the defense as far as the Flyers are concerned. I think the forward position is strong as you can possibly be, especially up the middle, like you guys said. So the goaltending. Goaltending is the big thing I'd be asking right now.
I agree with Coatsy. Let's see where the goaltending goes. Michael Layton's back again. All he's got to do is continue where he left off last year.
For me, it's going to be special teams and, most importantly, the power play. A lot of options to use on the power play. So, again, Peter Laviolette has a challenge of keeping those guys happy, giving them ice time in key situations. And the power play, very good last year, especially in the playoffs, will have to be a major influence in games this year.
And I think the key will be some of the players who really perform well in the playoff run, Scott Hartnell, Ville Leino, they have to continue that and show that it wasn't just in the playoffs that they can do it for an entire season. That's it for this edition of Big Mouse. Back with more from the Wells Fargo Center after these messages. Three-two Devils on top through two periods here at the Wells Fargo Center. Welcome back. And, you know, training camp is all about getting in condition, getting the systems down. It's also about sorting out. And the Flyers do have some sorting out to do, especially at the center ice position.
Yeah, Jeff Carter playing the wing in this game, as he did in the Stanley Cup Finals last year. Played with Mike Richards and played with Mike Richards tonight with Zhirdev on the other side. I thought Carter's looked a little more comfortable on that side, actually. He's had some scoring opportunities, did pick up a goal at 4-on-4, and he's had a couple of chances going down the right side. So it'll be interesting to follow him during camp and see how he progresses.
Well, we talked to the guy who has to sort it all out. He's the head coach, Peter Laviolette. How's he going to handle four centers for three spots?
We've got the four centermen, and there'll be times when one of our centermen has to play the wing. I feel like they all want to play center. I know, and they're good down the middle, and I think that's a bonus for us to have four guys that fill those top three spots. But somebody's got to play the wing, and I talked to all of them about it. At times, somebody's going to have to bump over from game to game. We hope that we're healthy. We hope that we have to manage that situation the entire year. Through the course of the game, you might see Richards at center for a period or for a few shifts, and then maybe it's Carter, or there can be bumping around. I think that they're movable parts. It's a place where you start to drop the puck, and then from there the game kind of moves all over the map. So from the starting point, maybe who's hot on centerman? Who's hot on the draws? Maybe Richards is having a great night. Maybe he plays center the entire night.
Yeah, depth at center ice, never a problem in the National Hockey League. Of course, the Flyers in the division with Malkin and Crosby and Staal up the middle in Pittsburgh. They have more depth there as well. Blair Betts, the fourth line centerman, that's very capable to step up and jump up in the lineup. And Darryl Powell has played the wing at times, another guy that's been a centerman for most of his career early on. So the Flyers have a lot of options down the middle, and that's a good thing.
Yeah, in September seems like maybe too much, but by November, December, you're going to need that depth for sure. We'll look ahead at the schedule, preseason, and the opener when we return after this. Tonight's third period on the Comcast Network is brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. And
as we get set to start this third period. Changes at both ends of the ice in goal.
Mike McKenna in goal for the New Jersey Devils now. Played a few games with the Tampa Bay Lightning a couple of seasons ago. And Sergei Bobrovsky in goal for the Philadelphia Flyers. 22-year-old rookie, signed as an unrestricted free agent. Played in the KHL last year. And Jeff Reese, the Flyers goaltending coach, very high on that man.
A lot of people are. They really like his quickness post to post. He's obviously a guy that hasn't had a ton of experience, but they really like what they see, and obviously they're getting him some playing time in these games, so he's been impressive. Can we just call him Bob?
I wish.
A lot of the guys of the team are just calling him Bob, but I don't think I can get away with that when he makes the saves. Devils with a 3-2 lead as this third period is underway. Alexander Urbom got that puck through center, and Flyers able to take over there. Here's Kimmo Tiiminen. Kimmo has a long pass there looking for Guerin out of his reach. Will not be icing. Urbom back, Guerin on his tail. And now Langenbrunner. He's passed to Zubras, who drops it off for Arnott. Arnott back for Zubras. A chip shot that was blocked. And now Urbom around behind the net. That puck bounced a little. Otherwise, Bobrovsky would have had himself a real tester for the first shot on goal that he'd seen in an NHL game. That one, that rocket from Arnott, missed high and wide as well.
I'm all for calling him just Bob.
Yeah, when you were talking to Peter Laviolette, once he was asking the question, he just called him the Russian goalie.
Veteran move by Mr. Coates.
We all noticed that.
Make sure the coach knows how to pronounce his name, right? Put him on the spot.
I was putting him on the spot, and just thank goodness we only had one Russian goalie here at camp.
There's Zubris, stepped into by Bartulis as the puck squirts through to Sean O'Donnell. And now Bartulis turning with it. His right wing feed denied by the stick of Bashunov. He goes in on a breakaway. I'm in big trouble. The puck is blocked at the Philadelphia line, and here's Claude Giroux for some room, and then he's pitching one deep. He's going to chase himself. First one there. Explosive skating from Giroux. Centered it in front. Never got to foul. Second try. Goes back around behind to Nodal. Andreas Nodal ended up getting some playing time in those playoffs last year with all the injuries for the Flyers. Back to Powell. And now Zaros at the point, just backhanding it along. Giroux quickly out in front. Nodal a couple stabs at it. Save made McKenna. Rebound out to Giroux again. What a pass he made to set that all up. So quick getting it out in front. Now Nodal. Down and down low. Tiiminen circling. His pass off. Zaros the shot. Save McKenna. And he'll hang on. Good shift from that line.
Yeah, real energizing shift there. Claude Giroux leading the way. Andreas Nodal getting a couple of scoring opportunities in tight that Mike McKenna was able to handle. Nodal getting a great opportunity here in camp. And as you said earlier, JJ provided a very valuable role for the Flyers in the playoffs. And there he's battling for a loose puck.
You know, Jonesy, you mentioned the playoffs, and I thought his skating just got so much better as obviously he matures as a player, as a National Hockey League player. But he just didn't look out of place. He had a great work ethic, and he really did a good job.
Walker's shot here smothered by McKenna. And now Shelley and Lalonde look like they're going to go. Shelley's ready. He's dropped his gloves. LeBlanc finally does drop his, and they will have at it. Rabbit punches with the left by Shelley, and over the top with the right, he's hammering away. Still getting with those rabbit punches as well. Now LeBlanc trying to retaliate. Oh, over the top from Shelley, getting rid of the elbow pad. Now another cross, caught LeBlanc. LeBlanc in a defensive posture for the most part in this one. He's looking for that counterpunch again, I think, LeBlanc. There's a right that he tried to connect on. Shelley using his reach right here. And now over the top again. A body punch. One of those body punches with the equipment on. Now the rabbit punches from LeBlanc. With that left. He tries to come over the top with the right. LeBlanc now to the attack. Boy, give him credit. He hung in there real well, LeBlanc. Took some shots early, but we're late. Now Shelley over the top. These guys have got to be absolutely out of gas right here. And they're pushing and shoving, remember, for a long time. Shelley trying to go over the top. Linesman apparently going to wait for someone to fall before this one ends. Shelley's actually saying, I'm done. There you go. That one went a while.
Mr. Coates, I know you like those marathons.
Oh, that one, you hit it right on the head. They were just waiting for somebody to say, okay, that's enough. We're a little tired. Remember, that's LeBlanc's second fight of tonight's game. But a guy like Shelley's a big man. And when he was with the Columbus Blue Jackets, he would fight every game. They loved him in Columbus. And right there, another thing that we saw with Matt Walker, he gets the left hand going, but so does LeBlanc. They both have a hold of the sweater right in the neck area, and they're using that as leverage to be able to try to come back with the right hands. Now, Shelley got a little bit of the edge early, but I give LeBlanc a lot of credit for two things. First, for hanging in there, and second, for his second fight, fatigue-wise, for hanging in there.
Yeah, Shelley picked up the original penalty before when he did get the jump on LeBlanc, and LeBlanc has proven himself to be a much improved fighter so far in this game, and the Flyers loaded with toughness. Jody Shelley will lead the way in that department, and he has been a premier fighter in the National Hockey League for the last few seasons.
Top two players in active fights are on the same team now, Ian LeFerrière and Jody Shelley. Power play for the Devils as a result of the roughing minor to Shelley. In addition to the fighting majors on each player, Talinder back out green. He'll wind and fire, blocked by, you guessed it, Ian LeFerrière, laying out in front of a shot. That is remarkable.
Why not? Flyers partial season ticket plans are available now. Ticket packages are still available and fit any budget or lifestyle. Choose from four value pack 11 game plans and get great benefits, including discounts from box office pricing and playoff access. Lots of great stuff to watch, and players like Ian LeFerrière blocking shots and Jody Shelley dropping the gloves. The Flyers have a lot of elements that you're going to enjoy coming down the Wells Fargo Center and watching.
Here's Langenbrenner. He's call it remarkable what Ian LeFerrière did. I mean, you have to take into account what he went through last year. Remember, this is a preseason game, but there he is laying out in front of the shot.
You know what? Fans are going to be fighting each other to see who the fan favorite is on this Flyers team, because they got a load of guys with character led by LeFerrière, who they love so much from last season. And fans had the opportunity at Meet the Flyers to say hello and say thank you to Ian LeFerrière for his great efforts last season.
One of the great parts of that show, the interaction with the fans.
Unbelievable turnout this year.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, the turnout for training camp in general has been amazing. 1,800 the first day of camp, which they said set a record at the Virtua Skate Zone over in Voorhees. And boy, there's a lot of interest in this Flyers team, no question about it. There's a wraparound try by Clarkson. Actually, just a side angle where he just sort of shoveled it at the net, but it went right on through, and now it's stabbed down the ice by Holmstrom. Half minute remaining on the penalty to Shelley.
Fans at Meet the Flyers trying to get Bill Guerin to say something bad about his former Penguins teammates, especially Sidney Crosby. Of course, Bill Guerin having nothing of that. The Flyer fans don't forget a Penguin coming over in a Flyers uniform, and we're giving them the gears pretty good.
It's bouncing free here, and it's cleared by Nodal. Andreas Nodal pursuing the puck now. Matt Parenti goes back. They'll drop it. And Alexander Urban. And the 19-year-old defenseman sending it towards center. Deflects free. Flyers get to it. They're back to full strength. They misfire on a pass. Would have been icing, but Van Riemsdyk gets there to cancel. Now Briere holding, centering it in front. Stick was lifted. Back out it goes. Walker turns, fires. Blocked. Josefsson got in the way of that one. And then carries the puck to center, moves it ahead, and Zubris dumps it in. Approach the five-minute mark of this third period. Flyers need one to tie. Guerin smothered along the wall. Tulis over there. Guerin knocking man down. Shunov. Shunov stays with it. We give him credit there. He got it back out to the point, Salvador. And then back in along. A loose stick on the ice as the Flyers have a player without a twig. And that is Van Riemsdyk. Briere moved the puck down the ice, so no problem for the Flyers now as Van Riemsdyk goes to the bench. Shunov moving to the Philadelphia line, and offside is whistled.
Bill Guerin doing a nice job defensively there, battling for loose pucks. And Guerin will contribute at both ends of the ice. And right there, you'll see a little rough stuff in the back there. Our Wells Fargo check of the game is Bill Guerin looking for that loose puck, but in great position defensively, making sure that that puck is not turned over into the middle of the ice. And that's something that a veteran like Guerin with his wealth of experience, will make sure it doesn't happen too often.
Richards moving on up. He's out with Carter and Jaredev again. He finds the trailer Tiemannin with the pass off of Tiemannin's stick. And now the battle in the corner. Jaredev worked on by Coretti. Flying into the piles, Richards. Jaredev has it. Back for Richards. It went off his skate. Did not be handled, but now it bounces back to the captain. Richards, head fake around the other side. By the center, Jaredev shot! Save made by McKenna. Jaredev trying to go upstairs, but the big goalie got in the way. And now the Devils will move it in. Mayer taken to the wall by Tiemannin. And the puck worked free by Zubers. Has been a force in this game. Green across ice, Salvador. His shot blocked and bounces wide. Richards fighting off Palmieri, but couldn't clear the zone. Salvador will send it in along. And now here's Richards. Has a look. And it's Jaredev. Jaredev weaving his way around one in center, the right wing dish. Now back out in front. Jaredev didn't appear to see it coming. And now the Flyers have to hustle back. A rush for the Devils. Arnott. Eliash's pass for Langenbrunner. Rudder tipped away. He gets it back. And now it's Eliash in the corner. Looking for the captain, but it's tipped away by Coburn. Counter rush for the Flyers as Giroux crisscrosses with Coburn. And then he'll backhand around behind the net. Flyers get to it. Walker sending one toward the net. Blocked aside. Andy Green tried to clear. That'll be stolen by Giroux. Darts to it. Tried the drop pass, but he fanned on it a little bit and never got to Nodal. Andy Green there. Giroux got his stick on his pass, but it made its way to Salvador. And the Devils gain control. 12:45 remaining here in the third period.
Pretty good defensive play by Andy Green there, anticipating the drop pass from Claude Giroux and jumping up and making sure that Giroux couldn't get the open ice.
Great pass there from Giroux to Powell, but his shot deflected by Green up into the safety net. We'll be back.
I want to take you back into history with a flashback 9 years ago to a very emotional time, probably one of the most emotional times ever in this building. It was the first game between the Rangers and the Flyers after the horrific 9/11 attack. And it was a rough hockey game, a very, very tough hockey game. But during that hockey game, the President of the United States, George W. Bush, was put up on the arena vision to speak to the nation as well as to the people of the Wachovia Center that night. And after that, the game ended. Yes, that's right. The game ended prior to the original 60 minutes planned. And the team shook hands, and I'll tell you what, that was just unbelievable that evening.
Well, it was preseason, but it's certainly one of my top 10 all-time moments as being involved with the Flyers. The president came out between the second and third periods, and his speech went on longer than the intermission, so the teams came out, and then everybody, fans, players, broadcasters, all of us watching the president, of course, listening to his every word, as that was such an emotional time, and a perfect way to end it, a tie score, just let it end. You know, there are more important matters, and it was just one of those galvanizing events that you're at, where you were, again, I'm proud to be an American.
I was in the stands as a fan for that game and was just amazed at how everybody just stared at the big screen and watched it. It was awesome. And the players, everybody around, it was unbelievable.
For what the president was saying, yeah, it takes you back. 9 years ago today, that took place. And it's hard to believe it's been 9 years. And it's also hard for me to believe it's been 19 years to this day. Since I made the great decision and I married my wife Bernadette.
Congratulations. What did she get you for your anniversary?
I think it's still, I've been busy today. I'm working on her gift too. We'll get there. We wait for the off days. The off days, I have an off day coming up Thursday.
19 years is a gift, buddy.
How she's made it, I have no idea. There's a shot save made by Bobrovsky, and then he gets bumped into, but no penalty called. And the Devils get back to it. I believe that was the first shot on goal for the youngster right there. It was a tester. Zubris after it behind the net. And Zubris. Back out, and now across it comes to Corenti for his shot that sails high and wide. Fraser after it. Fired one in, batted away. Josefsson to it. Nice little pass. And now Zubris giving some room around. Tries the other side. Everything's covered. Zubris turning with it. His pass back to the point, Fraser. And Carter finally checks in, moves it to center. He then gets interfered with this Carter. There's a broken stick on the ice as well. Puck bounces free. Here's Richards cutting it on goal. McKenna makes the save. McKenna closing the pads and able to shut the door to keep his team on top.
He had his eyes closed, guys. Let me tell you this. He's a big man. But watch the move Rich is going to put on him. He's going to drop the shoulder. Now he's going to try to get him moving from left to right. Watch. Tries to get that 5-0 open. But McKenna closes it right at the last minute. And then when he did, you see, he was kind of like, have I got it? And he's asking his defenseman, do I have it? He had it right at the last second.
Nice stop there by Mike McKenna. And Nikolai Zhirdev was the guy that sent Mike Richards in on that breakaway attempt with a really nice pass in the neutral zone, and Richards was off to the races.
Of the many attributes we've been told about Nikolai Zhirdev, we've seen him play as a member of the Rangers and before that Columbus, but his passing has impressed me the most in this game. Jonesy, he sees the ice so well, offside the call here, but he has spotted some flyers and seems to catch them in stride. Another aspect of his game that is a strength. Tonight on Sports Night, get a full recap and reactions from the Flyers' preseason face-off against the Devils. Also, a complete breakdown of the Phillies-Braves game. And the latest is the Eagles prepare for the Jaguars. A little bit of surprising news involved in those Eagles. Don't miss Sports Night tonight at 10 only on Comcast Sportsnet.
Breaking news.
Yeah, breaking news.
Great tease.
I'm going to leave it right there? I know you, the reporter, and you want to give the...
I'm not giving
okay.
it.
Okay. Right.
I'm going to be watching to find
you
out.
You have to watch to find out. And while you try to figure out what we're talking about, we'll step aside. 3-2 Devils here in the third. There's your score here in the third period. 3-2 Devils, and you see the two goaltenders. Layton played the first two. Bobrovsky playing the third. Here's Peter Laviolette.
As far as the goaltending goes, I think that we'll try and get some full games in after we get past the first couple. You'll see splits tonight. We'll start Layton and then back it up with Bobrovsky and see what he looks like. He's looked really good in camp so far in practices. He's quick. He's looked good in the exhibition game, the scrimmages. He looked good. So this will be a chance for him to get some time. He'll play 20 minutes tonight, and then he'll get some time. Also, moving down the road, backing up a game, and maybe even a start.
So there you go. The 22-year-old will get some playing time. More than just this game, apparently. And so he's done something to obviously impress. And also, Johan Backlund is having some issues with injury, so he's not getting as much time as originally anticipated as McKenna covers the puck up.
More shots headed towards Mike McKenna this period. Bobrovsky would, I'm sure, like to see a little bit more action in front of his net, but the Flyers trying to battle back here. Mike McKenna's made a couple of terrific saves, and Bobrovsky didn't face a shot till about the 11-minute mark of this third period. He's going to have to paint that helmet pretty soon. But maybe he's old school. He's going to go with just that.
There's this shot from the point deflected by LaPerriere, but it went high and wide. McDonald with the initial shot. And Sean goes back to play. He'll bank that one ahead.
He's just waiting to find out where he's going to be before he paints it.
Good
well,
point.
That's true.
There's a lot of guys.
Thinking ahead.
Yep, this time of year.
Mills to the puck for the Devils, trying to get to the back end and get a shot on goal, but he could not. And then he paid. Holmstrom gave him a shot. Now centering pass by LeBlanc out in front of Palmieri. Goes through to Urbom, but he couldn't do much with it. But the Flyers try to get control, and finally they do as Bartulis will move it out to center ice. In the middle, Holmstrom. Off for Jody Shelley. A shot redirection and the save made by McKenna. Holmstrom got his stick on that. Now the other way goes Vishunov. Cutting on in, his pass. And that's deflected away, but now picking it up is Nielsen back across. And that one tipped away from Vishunov. And in the corner, the Flyers after it again. It bounces right out toward the slot area. And the Flyers never did get it out of the zone, but Mayer fans on the pass gets it back. And then the save by Bobrovsky off of Nielsen. What a save there. He showed some of that great quickness that they've been telling us about. Briere across. Van Riemsdyk. Down behind. Bill Guerin trying to center. Parenti has it. And he'll send it off the glass to the neutral zone.
What a save. That was great anticipation and the quickness to get across. The Devils with a prime scoring opportunity. And Bobrovsky keeps this a 3-2 game.
Teaming in, moving up, bounces one toward McKenna. He'll just scoop that and hang on.
Flyers had a prime scoring opportunity just before that. Jody Shelley with a nice pass here. Ben Holmstrom, the redirection, goes through the legs of McKenna, but out the other side. And then the Devils have a quick chance.
Watch him go pipe to pipe. and he was way ahead of it. That was really the whole key is,
who is
what
that
Josie
now,
said. Beg your pardon?
Who went pipe to pipe there?
Bobrovsky.
There we go. You just said
it. You
him.
Don't think that I can say it.
Oh,
right?
I know. We've been noticing Bobrovsky, how you've been
Bobrovsky,
avoiding it.
Bobrovsky.
You can say it better than I can then.
But I want to say
three times,
Bob.
No way.
I want to say Bob.
Yeah, he is quick, that's for sure.
Bob's
yeah.
quick.
Yeah.
Right, Jonesy?
Very.
Teammates call him Bob, but it's Bobrovsky. And he's opening some eyes here early in camp. Mike Richards stopped at his own line. Zubris gets control. His pass off a skate. Mazaros going back. Josephson after it for the Devils. Clarkson comes in to take over. Back to Josephson. Around behind the Philadelphia net. Zubris got his free arm around teaming in, but no penalty call. To be honest with you, I think they've let a little go here in this game in terms of the clutching and grabbing and some of the interference. More than usually early in preseason, they're going to really set the tone.
Preseason for the refs and linesmen as well, as they get their legs moving and get back going for another National Hockey League season.
Keep the game going kind of thing.
You got it.
Clarkson moving on up. Dances around O'Donnell. David Clarkson cutting up. Nice play by Oscar Bartulis. Just calmly swept the puck away. 6.5 remaining. Flyers need one to equalize. Bill Guerin swooping out to center ice. Gains the red line and fires into the right of McKenna. That's Henrik Delinder. Alexander Urbom. Won't hit the linesman in center. Then is batted into the Philadelphia zone. Bartulis cuts over to get to it. Banking it out to the neutrals on a race there. It's tipped by Tolino away from Garrett, but there's Briere with the shot. He scores! Denny Briere ties this game at 3 with a laser as he beats McKenna. And he has the scoring touch that he showed in that playoff run right there. And this game is deadlocked. Briere scoring for a case of Tasty Cake.
Well, what a shot by Danny Briere. The loose puck there, Bill Guerin pressuring the defense. And then look at Briere use the screen there. McKenna can't come up with the high blast.
So, how about this? Right there, you can see McKenna goes down into the butterfly. Now, we've seen that so many times where Briere has the opportunity to wind up and let it go. But look where the glove is. The glove's down. So when he is a big man, he's got two things against him here. He's down in the butterfly, and he's got his glove down. So now he's got to wait for his glove to come back up, and there just isn't time with that rocket by Briere.
That was indeed a rocket. So we start over with just less than 6 minutes remaining here in the third. Look out, Mills, a turnaround shot and a save made by Bobrovsky. Flyers having trouble moving that puck ahead, and finally it's just dumped out and down the ice. This nodal, and it is icing. As Leander won the race. Unassisted goal, they say, for Briere.
Heads up play, though, by Bill Guerin at the offensive blue line. He did pressure the Devils' defense and then made sure that he stayed onside, allowing Danny Briere to walk in and blast that one. And obviously his confidence at a high since becoming a Philadelphia Flyer after that playoff run of last season. Looking for that to continue through the start of the regular season. He's back at center ice, and boy, does he look comfortable in that spot.
Langenbrenner moving on up. His shot is deflected, and it does go out of play. 5:27 remaining in the third. Danny Briere has made this a new game, tying it at 3. Patented celebration.
Well, let's take a look at our Toyota turning point with the Devils and the Flyers tied at 3 apiece, and it comes with the Flyers down 3-2. Just 6 minutes to go, and Briere with the opportunity to wind up. Look at his head. His head's up. He knows exactly where he wants to go with it. McKenna's a big man, but he took himself right out of that element when he went down in the butterfly, and Briere shoots it real good when he has that opportunity, and bang. Up over the shoulder of McKenna, and we're tied at 3 with 5:27 remaining in the third period.
Devils back to get the puck here. Ready to Fraser. And a head off a stick deep into the Philadelphia zone. Jamie Langenbrenner battling with Timo Timonen. Puck comes out into the slot off of Carter. And Zhaerdev surges to it. Zhaerdev flipping it ahead, hoping for Richards. Mike will get to it, but then is greeted by Coretti. Pushes through that check. Richards then trying to go cross ice, but that's tipped. Timonen sweeping at it. Langenbrenner trying to gather, but Zhaerdev knocked it away from him. Now the pass back to Jaredev. He overskates. Flyers able to recover. And there's Timonen. That was nearly too many men on the ice. Looking around, seemed like a lot of white jerseys out there, but not a problem. Briere redirects the puck into the double zone. Salvador and Briere after it, get their sticks tied up. Guerin arrives, gets to the puck. Bill Guerin turning with it. And the shot blocked, went off of Green. Great work there by Van Riemsdyk to get it back for a moment, but then the Devils recapture, and it's Green ahead. Kishunov now will move it ahead. Brodsky stops the puck, tries the glass. It's knocked down by Nielsen. Kishunov there. Briere gets to him. And Briere will work the puck to the other side of the ice. As Nolan is there, his pass in the middle to James Van Riemsdyk. Lone Ranger rush here for James. He's going to swing wide and try the shot, but Green got his stick on it. Nolan turning with it. And to drop it back off from his fanny, will move the puck into the corner. Giroux and after it, so is Nodal as he crashed the net, but Green got it to the corner, but Giroux picks it up. Giroux the pass to Powell. Powell cutting to the middle. And try to pass for Nodal. It was disrupted. Engel's shot goes wide. Now Green, checked by Nodal. Andreas Nodal wins that battle, got it back. Coburn shot. Tried to deflect it with Giroux, but it went on through and skipped out of play.
Well, you don't want to miss out. Philadelphia Flyers individual game tickets are on sale now. This Flyers season is packed with great opponent matchups, promotional games, and giveaways. For tickets, you can call 800-298-4200 or visit philadelphiaflyers.com. Season gets underway October the 7th on the road. First home game, October the 11th. A Monday night matchup with the Colorado Avalanche.
Wait for the regular season to start. Seven more preseason games, though, for the Flyers as they have a lot of things to look at. Here's Carter winning a battle. Got it out in front. Richards, a backhander. Save McKenna. He didn't get much on it. Now Coburn to shut off the post. It changed direction and then clanked off iron. Clarkson the other way. Coburn rotates back and stays with him. Ties him up. And the Devils have control as we tick below 3 minutes to play in the third. It's heated up here. And Walker, a pass up the middle. Nice tip pass from Carter to Richards, but he couldn't get it past the Devils' defense. Now they move up with it. It's a shot. Mills, and the save made. Bobrovsky floats back toward the Philadelphia zone, and Walker will send it off Richards' stick through center. Flyers will change. That pass in center, tipped away by Briere. Now Oscars Bartulis has it. Drops it to O'Donnell. O'Donnell ahead. Off the stick of Van Riemsdyk. Briere. Around behind, Van Riemsdyk will turn with it and then roll it around behind the net for Guerin. Guerin thumped to the wall, the puck back out toward the point. O'Donnell uses his chest to keep it in. Now it's tipped past him. Look out. Devils moving up. Here's Langenbrenner with Arnott. Langenbrenner has it. His pass to Arnott, cutting on in. Save! Bobrovsky! He flashes some leather and says no. And this game stays tied at three.
Flyers had a scoring opportunity down the other end just prior to that. Braden Coburn walked into this one and went off a stick in front and off the goal post. And then the Devils get the opportunity coming back the other way. And Bobrovsky robs Arnott on the backhand attempt there, showing great quickness and a fast glove.
Well, Arnott tried to fool Bobrovsky because he tried to make Bobrovsky go across the goal crease area and flip it the other way. He didn't go for it. And that glove hand was waiting for that puck right at that far pipe.
Well, he is a goalie who plays with some flair. There's no question about that. Fraser, big hit there on Nodal. It also disrupted a potential chance for Nodal to get to that puck on a break. Timonen, Mazaros moves his way in across the line and then wrists one into the midsection of McKenna, who will just pin that one against his body. And then Mayer and Nodal, some pushing and shoving, nothing too serious.
Nodal's had a pretty good effort out in this game here tonight. Darryl Powell also picked up a goal. Bobrovsky has really put together a nice third period here. Didn't have much action for the first 10 minutes, but Danny Briere got the Flyers tied up at 3-3.
One of three goal scorers for the Flyers, a case of Tasty Cakes each. And we welcome back Tasty Cakes as a sponsor this year. Every time the Flyers score, you'll hear me say, the score is for a case of Tasty Cakes. I've had some players ask me for their Tasty Cakes.
Darn right.
I do not control that. Somebody else
gets. Oh, they'll find them. Don't worry. Yeah. They'll track them down and make sure they get
it. Here's Kimmo Timonen. Wristing one. That one He's bounced wide. If I was in control of it, they may never get him.
That's correct. Coltsy likes his tasty cakes. There's no doubt about
the
that.
Chocolate peanut butter one.
Oh, yeah.
But kept it here by Mazzaros. 1:33 to play in the third. And, yes, there is overtime in the preseason. Puck bouncing around to the corner. Zheredev. Get some help from Timonen around behind Richards. Richards looking in front. Timonen! McKenna got a piece, and it didn't quite get in. It stayed in the blue paint. Now Richards centering again for Zheredev, but it's broken up. Richards after it again. As Richards in that line looking as though they didn't want overtime, but McKenna got just enough of that Timonen redirection in front. Now here's Clarkson, and he get back up the wall. Briere has Elias all over him. Into the final minute of regulation. Timonen, through Carter, look out. The leader got it to Clarkson, and he is stopped in tight by Mazzaros, and the Flyers clear all the way down. This will be icing unless Van Riemsdyk can win the race. Oh, he tried to lift the stick of Talinder, but apparently did not.
Flyers with another prime scoring chance as Kimmo Timonen jumped into the fray right there, redirecting that puck through the legs of McKenna, and Andy Green alertly tracked that puck down. There you see it bounce through, and number six, Andy Green, is there to clear it out of harm's way. Flyers can't get that one to fall in past McKenna as he slides across right there.
Just got a piece of it with the back pad, it looked like, as he spun around.
He's been busy in the third period. Flyers closing the gap and shots on goal. Devils still 28-25 as timeout for Peter Laviolette, who has a great history of calling timeouts at the most opportune times.
Certainly one of the most famous timeouts in Philadelphia sports history right here. His team down 3-0 in game 7 against Boston after, of course, having trailed in the series 3-0. They made it to game 7 in Boston. And you can see what he's saying right there. Get one back here. Get one back. James Van Riemsdyk would come up with that first goal to start the historic comeback in that game as the Flyers on their way to a game 7 victory.
Now you remember JVR's shot, it actually hit the stick of Stewart, broke the stick of Stewart, redirected, and then went right through the legs of Rask. And that's just, when you got things going, you got them going. Doesn't matter how they go in. And so Peter Laviolette, absolutely, that timeout. I mean, every timeout he seems to take last year was just right on the money.
Off the draw is a shot, blocked, and Carter was a step away from breaking out. Now Timonen has it, 35 seconds remaining in the third. He's turned back, so he'll just shuffle the puck deeper into the Devil's zone. Elias is there. Dropping it off. Arnott ahead. Langenbrenner couldn't get it past Van Riemsdyk. Now Guerin moving on in. Guerin to the backhand shot. Save McKenna. Got it with his stick. Now Elias to Arnott. To the Philadelphia line. Back in front. That one goes all the way through. 10 seconds in the period. Back out to the point. Urbom around behind for Elias. Elias trying to get it in front. Stopped. And Stevenson and Bobrovsky were both there. Now Talinder's shot goes high and wide, and yes, preseason game number one needs overtime to determine a winner. 3-3 the score. Billy Guerin almost the hero late in regulation.
Yeah, Bill Guerin with a scoring opportunity. Went to the backhand, and Mike McKenna makes a real nice save. Look at Guerin protect the puck from Langenbrunner, and the quick backhand goes off the blocker of McKenna and heads the other way. Van Riemsdyk with the pass to Guerin to start the offensive opportunity, and McKenna in good position to keep that one out of the goal.
Bill Guerin, a two-time Stanley Cup winner, 14 years between the two cups. Flyers have, of course, Chris Pronger, who, by the way, is recovering from knee surgery, so he's not an active participant in training camp yet. He is on the ice, but not in team drills or in any kind of contact yet. But they have Chris Pronger and now Sean O'Donnell, who was with Pronger when he won his cup, as former Stanley Cup winners.
We can't have enough of them. And the New Jersey Devils have enough in their fold. John McClain, one of those guys. There's the update on Chris Pronger's injury, an off-season knee surgery. His status is day-to-day. That is great news. And the ice time numbers just amaze. Yeah. Every time you read them, it's scarier. The guy just logs a ton of minutes. But having depth on the blue line like the Flyers have this season is going to help Peter Laviolette limit some of the huge minutes that Pronger plays, but you have to wonder how much will be taken back. He loves to be on the ice and demands the ice time because of his great play.
Well, you know, you think about him not getting as much time in preseason, I think that's fine.
as much ice time as he gets. And certainly he will get less time than last year, but he's still going to log a lot of minutes. When you have Chris Pronger on that bench, that tendency to put him out there is always there. So, you know, he's just going to miss some time here, but I think hopefully he'll be ready for the regular season opener. Not 100% sure of that as yet.
You know, what's really amazing is the core four, Coburn, Carl, Tiemannin, and Pronger, only missed three man games last year. That is an amazing stat.
Indeed. And they were the big four, certainly in the playoffs. We are in overtime here now, 25 seconds in. Sudden death, four aside. And if there's no winner after the overtime period, a shootout.
Both teams have scored at 4-on-4 in this game. Jeff Carter picked up the goal for the Flyers, Adam Mayer for the Devils. And with the extra skating room, both teams very capable of producing the 4-on-4 situation.
Here's Andy Green. He's dangerous in a 4-on-4. In the defensive mood, he moves up a lot. He's moved up right here. His pass behind the net for Eliash. He's checked by Coburn. Patrick Eliash lost the puck. Van Riemsdyk gets to it, but he's got plenty of Devils around him. He does well to get that puck free. And now the Flyers will look to move up. Cross-ice pass from Briere was knocked down. Now here's Van Riemsdyk, full flight to center. Van Riemsdyk barreling on in, but ran out of room. There is a penalty coming up. Flyers had the puck, delayed call. Point shot, Mazaros, and that's blocked in front. Devils will get to it here. And there is your whistle. So the Flyers will have a 4-on-3 advantage here as the speed of James Van Riemsdyk and the tenacity drawing a penalty.
Well, this is the confidence level we were talking about. Now watch, he's just going to go right around. Now right there, you see Bryce Salvador gets that left arm right into James Van Riemsdyk. That's the penalty. But look at the strength of this young man trying to use his body to bring that puck in front and then be able to get a good shot. Salvador basically did a pretty good job of shutting it off, but when he got the arm into him, that's where the penalty occurred.
Their first legitimate power play of the game. They had an 8-second power play earlier on, so they'll go to work here for the Flyers with a 4-on-3. They send out Carter, Briere, Richards, and Tiemannin. Here's Tiemannin getting it back to Richards. He'll wait, wine, fire save, McKenna as Carter tried to cut in front of him. Now Carter off the wall with it, turns and takes the shot, save McKenna, the rebound, bounces free, Richards shuffles it off to Carter, who had a little trouble gaining control. Pulls it all the way back out, now to Tiemannin with 3:18 in the overtime, buck 38 in the power play. Tiemannin to Richards. Right back to Tiemannin, now Richards the one-timer, wide. Carter had set up the screen, but Richards missed the target. Now it's Briere. Holding on, back out, takes the return feed. Briere, the shot blocked. Adam Mayer, Green were both there, and now Green clears the zone.
Good job defensively by the New Jersey Devils, not allowing Danny Briere a whole lot of room to fire that shot through to the front of the net.
Right back in go the Flyers. Tiemannin has a look. Moves to Richards. Carter is right in front of McKenna. Richards holding, pass to Briere. Briere back to Richards, shot, and he was looking for a redirect from Carter, but it was knocked away, and now Coretti a chance to clear, and he did get it over the head of Tiemannin and down the ice. 48 seconds on the power play. 2:25 in the overtime. Here's Richards revving it up to center. Richards in across the line. Richards the move to the backhand. Richards all the way around. Centered it, it went off Eliash, back out to Tiemannin. And now a pass down low to Zhirdev. Zhirdev back out to Richards, across for Tiemannin. Tiemannin a shot, loved by McKenna as Van Riemsdyk was trying to get a piece of it.
McKenna doing a nice job and looking around the big body of James Van Riemsdyk. Tiemannin alertly firing that puck towards the goal, and Mike Richards doing a nice job weaving through the neutral zone and around a couple of defenders. Nobody there to get that loose puck, but a good attempt by Richards nonetheless.
Well, Talinda got a little bit caught looking down. When he got caught looking down, Richie came with a little bit of a toe drag to bring that puck up and then up onto the back end. What a great job there.
And the Devils able to clear. That leaves the Flyers time for just one more foray in the offensive zone with this power play. Zhirdev to Giroux. Giroux gets in. Giroux holds on. Back out. Shot. Mazzara save. McKenna rebound. Zhirdev digging away, but McKenna able to cover. Flyers have overtaken the Devils now in shots in this game. McKenna's been good.
He's been very good and very lucky around that five-hole area. He doesn't leave his stick in front there, so the Flyers have been trying to get one past, and McKenna's had some fortunate bounces, but he's been in very good position. And right there, the redirection by Zhirdev right out in front of McKenna was unable to get that puck past him.
Power play is over right now. Back to 4-on-4. Here's Giroux. Back out. Mazaros, the blast. And that glanced off of McKenna and wide. Big hit by Salvador on Giroux, but he had braced himself. The puck goes to the corner. 1:26 in the overtime. Andy Green settling things. Finds to Leander. Now Clarkson. Clarkson in on the right wing. Forced outside by Bartulis. Clarkson turning with it. Pass back to the point. Intercepted. Here's Briere. Briere to Van Riemsdyk. Goes wide on the left side. Van Riemsdyk, the shot! Save McKenna. That had a lot of juice on it. Time now for the Devils moving back. Zubris for Clarkson. Couldn't come up with it. O'Donnell stops the rush. Van Riemsdyk picks up the puck. James Van Riemsdyk. JVR the other way. The shot and the save McKenna. Van Riemsdyk to the carom, and he's got two Devils to deal with, and they come away with the puck. 40 seconds remaining. Alexander Urban moving it ahead. Coretti to the Philadelphia line. Dropping it back. Urban will dump it into the corner. Teaming in there. Half minute remaining in the extra session. Urban hands off. Here's Elias getting it in front. Bounces free to Briere. And he's just going to clear the zone. 17 seconds. Still time for the Devils. The pass ahead to Elias. Elias moving on in. Winds, fakes, and then takes the shot. Save made by Bobrovsky. Whoa. A little pass there was Richards. It's a turnover. Still 6 seconds. Puck back out, and the shot by Toledo is blocked. Bounces free. Green after it. Tried to center. It's blocked, and that does it for overtime. Bobrovsky late had to come up with a big stop. McKenna before that with several stops. And as a result, this one goes to a shootout.
Bobrovsky 6 saves now on the 6 shots that he's faced. The last one, a tricky one by Patrick Elias, a very dangerous goal scorer who had the puck in a prime scoring position.
We'll be back with the shootout, as that will settle the first preseason game right after this. Been an entertaining hockey game. Flyers and Devils, the first preseason game of this training camp. And, well, it's going to end in a shootout, but let's look back and see how we got to this point.
Yeah, Flyers got off to a quick start in this one. Claude Giroux getting that puck to the front of that, and Darryl Powell puts the goal in for his first of the preseason, the Flyers' first of the preseason. Jeff Carter came right back after that, gave the Flyers a 2-0 lead there, putting that puck through the legs of Johan Hedberg, and it was the Devils' turn. Adam Mayer redirects Henrik Tillander's shot from the point. That made a 2-1 after one for the Flyers. Devils, very good second period. Former Flyer Dinas Zubris picks up a goal, and then Jamie Langenbrunner, the captain, gives the Devils a 3-2 lead. That woke the Flyers up, and in the third period, Danny Briere blasts that one past Mike McKenna, and Danny Briere is ready to go here in the shootout.
And he, of course, has been very good in shootouts. And here he comes. Briere deliberately on in the deke, and McKenna kept the pad there to make the save. Great job by the goaltender.
Well, McKenna, he's just going to wait. Remember, those who go first lose. Now, Briere's going to drop his shoulder, but McKenna stayed right with him. And McKenna's a big man, remember. So now when he goes down to that butterfly, that left pad came out. Boy, he just flashed it.
Jamie Langenbrunner, good percentage in his career as he cuts on in, winds and blasts, and Bobrovsky says no.
Great patience from Bobrovsky here as Jamie Langenbrunner walks in and tries to beat the rookie and very patiently makes the save and knocks it away.
Nikolai Zhirdev, 13 for 33 in his career, gets his first try and a shootout as a Flyer. See what he has up his sleeve. Deliberately moving on in and could not make it home. I don't know as if McKenna got a piece. Coach, you had a better angle maybe?
Well, he right at the last second he did, but when you take a look at this, he's going to make about 4 moves here. Very quick, bang, 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 and then right at the last second, you see that puck deflect off of the blocker. But Zhirdev slowed down, who I think gave a little bit of an advantage to McKenna.
Now Patrick Elias Swinging way to the right, then cutting back to the middle. Bobrovsky closes the pads and makes the save.
Again, great patience from Bobrovsky as Patrick Eliash slowly winds his way into the offensive zone, tries to go five hole, and Bobrovsky's there to close the door with a good play with a stick.
Claude Giroux with a shootout opportunity here at the Wells Fargo Center. Remember his last one, he dekes on it and scores! Another thing of beauty from Claude Giroux as he went to the backhand and beat McKenna.
Well, you see McKenna ends up in the net because Giroux's moving in with such speed, makes a nice move to the one side. That really froze McKenna. So once he does go back to the forehand and back to the backhand, McKenna's still coming from the other side. Boy, what a great, great shot because he had a lot of room with that backhand.
Now a save here, and the Flyers win the game. Jason Arnott moving on in, and he scores! He snuck it through Bobrovsky, and we play on.
Arnott looking up to the sky after this one. He didn't get all of it, but got enough of it as he went through the five hole on Bobrovsky. Bobrovsky closed the door on Eliash, couldn't do so on Arnott.
Now the captain, Mike Richards, will try to put the Flyers back on top. McKenna coming away out to greet Richards, who makes the deke and scores! Richards going the backhand from the angle, pumps it home.
Well, that's his patented move. What he does, he puts a little delay. When he does the delay, he's coming on the backhand, and watch McKenna. McKenna goes for it, and as soon as he stretches right out, Richards is already by him, so he fires it between the pad and the pipe.
Jakob Josefsson cutting on in. Deeks and could not score. Bobrovsky got a piece, and the Flyers win the hockey game. So Sergei Bobrovsky, a win in his first appearance in a National Hockey League game. Richards got what turned out to be the game winner in the shootout. Bobrovsky got the job done at the other end.
Well, Mike Richards scores the big goal, and what about Bob? Bobrovsky comes up with a nice save at the other end. Very patient. Again, covers a lot of net for a guy that doesn't appear to be huge in stature, but very aware of where he's at in goal and does a nice job here and gets the victory for the Flyers.
You can really tell an awful lot about a goalie in a one-on-one situation like that in his rookie game. I mean, he looked spectacular. I mean, this guy has got unbelievable speed in that goal.
Let's take a look at our Bud Light player of the game, Danny Briere. Right where he left off in the playoffs last year. He had that huge final against Chicago where he picked up 12 points. Here he starts off the preseason with a big goal in the third period. The blast right there beats Mike McKenna high to the glove, and Briere gives a little fist pump and gets some congratulations from his teammates. Bill Guerin right in the mix there as well.
So the Flyers start their preseason with a win, a shootout. Victory over the Devils, 4-3. Tonight's Flyers-Devils game was brought to you by BWLocal.com. Go to BWLocal.com or your area Volkswagen dealer to learn more about great deals on all their new vehicles. By Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. And by Wells Fargo, when you're considering buying your first home, Wells Fargo is with you. Wells Fargo, together we go far. We're back with you later on in the preseason when the New York Islanders come to town. The Islanders and Flyers in preseason action here at the Wells Fargo Center. September the 29th, a 7 o'clock start. Flyers and Islanders renew hostilities. Another Atlantic Division rivalry. Flyers-Islanders, September the 29th at 7 o'clock on the Comcast Network. And so the Flyers play inside this building. Called the Wells Fargo Center for the first time for one of their games, and a lot of newcomers getting their first taste of action wearing the orange and black, and it turns out to be, yes, a tempestuous affair, but one in which the Flyers get the victory. For the entire crew, as well as my partners Keith Jones and Steve Coates, I'm Jim Jackson. Good evening from the Wells Fargo Center.